You're the light that helps me find my way. You're the words when I have nothing to say.
So shut your meat hole for a second and listen to me.
And in this world where nothing else is true, here I am still tangled up in you. I'm still tangled up.
But just listen to me for 5 seconds.
All right, relax, relax.
You're the fire that warms me when I'm cold.
Boy, I'd really like to chew on my crotch right now.
You're the hand I have to hold as I grow old.
Please pull down your underpants. Just stick it in there?
How long has it been since this storyline began? And I hope it never ends and goes like this forever. In this world,
Danny and Ruby from Upon a Burning Body, and you're listening to PPRN. Yeah.
What's up? This is John from Darkest Hour, and you're listening to PPRN.
You're listening to PPRN, motherfucker.
I don't like you, and you don't like me.
Oh, for God's sake. Oh, what the hell? What the hell?
Could I stay on your gross couch?
I knew I should have stayed at the goddamn motherfucking titty-sucking piece of shit, stupid-ass dog dick-licking fucking Holiday Inn.
Wait for them to ask you. What's up, everybody? I can't hear myself.
Hey, hey, hey.
What's up?
Hello. Oh, here we go.
Hello. Hello, hello.
The car
can't
is
wait
working.
To get the new mics. Yeah.
Boop.
We're live. It's Tuesday.
Oh, yeah.
Hello.
This is going to be the last Tuesday before we start UConn.
What are you doing?
Last Tuesday. I hope there's more Tuesdays.
What's the matter?
Oh, you like that director's chair. That's what you've been looking for.
The comfy chair.
Am I going to move you?
Am I not?
You have to sit in the tree when you sit in that seat.
Yeah, he's buried in the tree. Look at him.
You're in the brush.
Talk.
The darkness.
Right here?
It consumes me.
What's wrong with your voice, dude?
You're very consumed over there.
Behind your voice.
I feel like I'm hiding.
He's hiding in the
booth. This is like my dating scene.
That's what happens when you hire homeless people. They don't show up.
Maybe it's because we call him homeless.
You don't read
funny
the
how
Facebook
that works,
thing.
Peter.
He's not even on Facebook.
Yeah, he don't read that. I hope he, you know. Somebody probably took
we
his
We called
house.
Him homeless on the air.
He technically is.
Yeah.
Burned him.
Weeks ago. The residents in Peard.
We got Eugene Gallagher here.
That's me. Hi.
First time in the new studio.
Yeah.
It's so nice. It's
Did
beautiful.
You decide if you wanted to go to UConn at all?
I would love to go to UConn. I unfortunately, I'm too old and for college, and I don't have any money. I used to play basketball.
Kickstarter.
But, you know, my knees.
No, do a radio show.
Oh, yeah, definitely do. Down for that.
Pick a Thursday. We'll put you on.
It's kind of a big question, Peter.
Peter, you want to get on one?
That's how I know social media don't work. I've only been saying UConn for 3 months.
Peter, get down on one knee. It might be more romantic.
I'm not getting on nobody's knee for UConn. You either come or you don't.
If you don't like it, get out.
I can walk right through campus and find anybody to interview.
I want to come.
Yeah, no, that sounds
stupid. You want to come every night. What are you talking about?
Poor thing.
Ew.
Can't bang her. I got staph infection.
Yikes. Oh, sorry to hear
staph
that.
Infection. They don't show up.
Yeah, no bueno.
Yeah, don't bang your staff.
Ricky kept saying, that thing's getting bigger. I'm like, yeah, it's just a zit. I shaved it on Tuesday night.
I told him not to.
Wednesday was like getting bigger.
You just got
to
poke it. And
Thursday
it,
was like the size of a fucking quarter.
Man, out of context, this just sounds horrible.
Friday got the size of a fucking
And it's only 7:30.
Yeah, I know, right?
Golf ball.
Wow. Hey, leave golf balls out of this.
When do you, at what point do you go to the walk-in clinic and say,
Saturday.
Hey, there's something wrong?
Sunday afternoon, 4 p.m.
The thing is, though, is I didn't have a fever. I wasn't walking funny. It was just a big lump on my belly with a big red spot. So
yeah.
And then you put it on Facebook, and everybody's like, oh, he's dying. He's this. He's that. Like,
oh, that was on your stomach? Thank God. I was like,
stomach.
Where is that from?
Know,
that
like
was so head. Close.
Indeterminate
splotch.
Those other pictures you're sending out into people's death thread. Oh, my God.
I was like, man, you're letting your dick go.
I had, what did I have? I had five different diseases people were saying. Oh, you better go get it. Look, that's Mesa or Mesa, whatever, Mercer.
Oh, you got like, the comments where like, everyone's telling you what the fuck
oh,
it is.
Oh, my God, that's lethal. Then some guy's private messaging me. I don't mean to scare you, dude, but you better get to the hospital now. I'm like, dude, I wrote on my thing. I was at the hospital three times. Oh, no, you better get there now.
I love how the doctors
I was
are
there
like,
three times. What do you want me to do?
I love how everyone's a doctor now with WebMD.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God. That's the worst.
Listen, I typed it three times and... Growth with boom. No, that's not it. Growth with black. No, that's not it.
It told him he was pregnant.
I wish he was like a Siri. You could say, I got a red fuck. No, here's a picture.
You are not the father.
Yeah.
But then I found out we have an insurance, and our insurance, we can Skype a doctor.
Well, yeah. Like with with house calls. They used to make house calls. It wasn't even that long ago. They made
Skype
house calls.
You could Skype a doctor and show him what's wrong, and he could tell you right there what it is.
And now you don't even need him to
maybe.
Come over. You could just.
Well, maybe.
Do
they don't even know what it is. They didn't even fucking.
They don't know.
They didn't know what it was. So they're like, you got a staph infection. I'm like, oh my God. I'm thinking about the NYPD Blue show where what's his name? Jimmy Smith died of a staph infection. I'm like, oh fuck. I'm dying. I'm telling Ricky.
Yeah, that's a dated reference.
This one would happen. I get my money and you get to keep it now.
Wait a second. When you said that your friend died of a staph infection, you were actually referring to NYPD Blue?
No. No, it was my friend Clam.
His buddy, Michael Chiklis.
I was everything, dude. I was, like, calling my kids.
Yeah, he came home. He's like, oh, we got to make this paste. I got to put this paste on.
Oh, and then a friend of mine is saying, use baking soda and water. Well, from what I used to use.
Draws the infection out.
Yeah, I used to use it for Coke.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it would draw all the chemicals out of it. Put it on my stomach, dude, and that's when everything started to go haywire.
Growing up, my mother would use toothpaste. It was like their Robitussin.
Yeah.
From the old country, like you burned yourself, she'd be like, put some toothpaste on it. Like she'd just get like,
well,
she'd
I mean,
put
you
it on there and rub it in.
When
man.
They first made toothpaste, it was basically baking soda with water.
Exactly. Oh, yeah. I mean, it for a lot of stuff, like for a quick burn,
it draws out a fucking infection, I'm telling you. That's
yeah, it does. Yeah.
That's when it started to get like to its peak.
And it makes my dick minty fresh.
We did. But it was just the pain was starting to get.
And it was looking pretty bad. It was really red around it. I was worried.
It still looks bad. It's a big hole like this.
Yeah, place. But now it's wow. a hole. It's drained at least.
And it's covered.
When I was a kid, it was Vicks Vapor Rub. That yes. cured everything.
Yep.
Robitussin.
Just rub that on there.
Then they fucking sit in there like I bring me back to my disease days when they used to stick that fucking Q-tip down your cock.
Ooh.
Check for
Ooh.
Syphilis. Well, they're stuffing
what?
Fucking.
The culture, yeah.
It looks like a tapeworm into your hole.
Yeah, that's the worst.
And she's like, does this hurt?
Like, no, it feels great. Can I get another?
Great.
You got a fucking 240-pound man crying on your table. What do you mean does this hurt?
He's like breaking my hand.
I had her hand. I'm biting my
yeah.
shirt.
When we were done, I had to go get x-rays on my hand.
She's like, I'll stop. I go, you think?
Even Ricky was crying. She's like, no, not his dick. Is he the only one getting penetrated? This is not fair.
I think I'm going to stay comfortably away from the mic tonight.
That's why the couch wow. is all yeah. messed up right now.
The only staph infection you'll get is just not showing up when you need to.
Just don't look God. At that quickly. Give it some time.
Yeah,
some
turn away.
Hey, Bob, when you lean into the mic like that, it looks like you're going down on someone.
Yeah, it does.
That person would appreciate it very much.
Bob's like, guess who's a mic next week?
That's a big
Bob on Bob action.
Put it in, take it up. Put it in, take it
up. Bob on Bob action.
No. I don't think Tracy would approve of that.
Oh.
You got a girlfriend now?
Yeah, for a couple months now.
Congrats.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
How'd you do that?
We never heard about this.
Well, because
she was at the wedding.
Yeah, but you
yeah,
haven't
but it
been
wasn't
posting
official.
Anything. There's nothing posted on Facebook.
Yes, there's no receipt.
Yes, there
I
is.
I haven't noticed anything.
Go take a look.
I give a shout out to my people in Rhode Island right now listening at the restaurant. So.
Well, I mean,
hey guys.
Hey girls.
Girls.
Rhode Island peeps.
Rhode Island.
They're at a fucking seafood restaurant right now.
I want to go to a seafood restaurant.
We go to a seafood restaurant once a week, sweetheart.
No, we don't.
Ricky's
it's called Pound Town.
Yeah.
No, you don't eat there.
I don't eat
you
there.
You don't
right.
eat there, huh?
I visit.
He doesn't go to Land Down Under
I
again.
Sit on the bench. Wow.
That got there quick.
If you don't eat the catch of the day, you are the catch of the day.
We were talking about eating each other's ass yesterday. She's like, you don't even eat my pussy.
Yeah, well, I'm like, there's no way you're
going there. It's not your wedding night.
There was definitely no way he's going there if he won't go down.
How delicious was your fart? Like, I guess if he's going to go there.
No. Well, that's what I told her. I said, you're sticking. When you fart, shit particles go around your ass into your pussy.
Yeah, but that's no excuse. Like, after
I would
I get
really
out of
like
the
to
shower.
See the science behind that. There's not what fucked up physics do you think happened?
It's,
like,
it's actually it's
staph infection and went right in her mouth.
It's a G-string theory. G-string theory.
Listen, yeah, I'll never have a good excuse for not eating pussy. All right,
you won't.
No, you won't.
You got to do it.
Yeah.
I don't have to do anything.
You should.
Yeah,
do it.
You should.
You should.
You know when Bob says it, it's been around.
Yeah. Ricky keeps right. telling me, she's like, I would never ever cheat on you. I said, every day I chisel away and not eating pussy, that I will never cheat on you. Just keeps going and going.
Becomes a little more hollow
yeah.
each time.
Yeah. I would never cheat on you
until I find someone who eats pussy.
Yeah. Exactly.
The statements will be different.
Yeah.
I would never cheat on you until you pushed me to this.
But see, that's oral sex, though. It's not really sex.
Bill Clinton.
Let me say that coming
yeah.
open this week.
Okay. If she doesn't
the guys
inhale,
got me a blowjob. I was okay. They got me a blowjob.
If she doesn't inhale,
Bill
you're
Clinton.
Good old Bill. Come on, baby. You know how it is.
Good job. Yes.
I didn't inhale, but she totally swallowed.
You're wrong. Okay.
That's was that true. Hillary or Monica?
I can't believe she kept the dress. It's such bullshit.
It was definitely Monica.
Holy fuck!
And that's why Hillary lost.
That was Mary.
All right, it's
or her too.
It's 2016 before we get into Bob's song. I saw a video today. Got a lot of responses for it.
Oh, that one.
A girl beating up a boy.
Yes.
I watched that.
A girl beating up a boy. Is it? He was raised right because he never put his hands on her once.
Wait.
But when is it time?
How was she beating him, like, actually
beating
him?
She was punching him in the face, like, beating him like a
boy. She was whooping him.
They were like high school kids.
She was
maybe
hitting him
middle
like
school,
a boy.
But yeah. There was an
age out there.
When is it right to hit back? Or is it ever right?
I think
ooh.
When it starts to, like, really her, like if she's like, you know, mousing up his eye.
She
like,
is.
Yeah. I well, think I, you're I don't think you should lay her out. I think you should, what do they call it? Use
shove her away or something, but just get
a good
bear hug. What do the police call it? Use proportionate force.
But here's the thing, once you put your hands on her, it's domestic.
It does,
no, it's
I think you should Pedro Martinez her and grab her by the head and drop her down like Zimmerman.
Did you guys? There was a video on, there was a viral video like last year. There was like a girl on the subway beating up a guy with like an eight ball jacket, and he laid her out. Like he laid her out, and he wasn't even arrested. And everyone was like,
problem is nowadays with all the laws and everything. If you're if you lay one hand on the girl or
I'm gonna tell you
I'm telling you from my father who's a former policeman, it doesn't matter anymore. Both of them go.
Yeah, well, that's what I'm saying.
Equal rights.
Assault's assault.
Exactly. Yeah. So okay? I mean, as soon
and actually, that's not assault. That's battery.
Right. Right, so I mean, nowadays there's really no self-defense.
Well, I think that if you can get away, just get away. Like if you can walk away from it,
exactly.
Yeah. Yeah, like if you're cornered and they won't get out of your way and they're hurting, like if you get hit by somebody and it doesn't hurt, like then you don't have to retaliate or anything.
See,
like that.
See, Ricky's that kind of girl. She likes to fight.
But if someone hits you and you are like, all right, you're threatening me, I will punch you, I will move you. I mean, if that was me, I probably would have just pushed her out of the way and
walked away. It got 22 million views.
Yeah,
and they were
wailing on him though. At some point,
she was beating him up like a government mule.
What did he do? What did he do?
Like I
just kept walking away.
But.
Well, the thing is, you can't look at it as like a man versus woman versus man. It's person versus person. If you're backed in a corner and it's life or death, like this person's gonna like fuck you up.
That's a different story.
Yeah, then defend yourself.
Because the problem though, we don't see what's on the other end. He could
exactly.
Her friends could be like, you touch her and your ass is beat.
True, but there's video.
Right, but who's watching? Who's doing the video?
Not only that, what happened before that to lead into this situation?
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, maybe he deserves to be. Maybe he was cheating on her or some shit. Who knows, man?
Maybe they were dating and he wasn't going down on her.
Oh, really?
Wow.
I've been there.
We could just slap the crap out of
her. Or maybe the mom.
I've been hit for that before.
Maybe he gave her a staph infection.
Oh.
Bitch.
Or a little HIV.
Oh, boy.
Hard.
That's the punch that keeps on burning.
Turn it into a thing.
Harden the vagina.
Guilty.
All right, let's go screw some sheep.
You ready for your song there, Barbarino?
I guess.
On that note.
Barbarino.
How many of these songs have you written? Can you hear me?
Yeah. Yeah. I've.
Can you hear me now?
For the show?
Yeah.
75.
Wow.
You've been on that long?
Yeah.
Wow,
last February we started.
Right. Put out a triple album.
We got to do a comment. Someone was supposed to do that, but...
they left.
They got a new radio station.
Oh, Jesus.
Awkward.
Bedroom pop, indie rock is here. Eugene Gallagher will endear. Melodies and lyrics that drive. We will hear some of them live. PPRN keeps it real. Human music and talk with zeal. Keeping you on an even keel. Peter's got the helm of the show. Keeping things revved up in the flow. Ricky keeps us all distracted. Her good looks keep us all attractive. PPRN keeps it real. Human music and talk with zeal. Keeping you on an even keel. Dennis Gifford's wit is quite quick. His quips will be very slick. Chris Bueno didn't stay around. A homeless guy still has a grin. PPRN keeps it real. Human music and talk with zeal. Keeping you on an even keel. Eddie O'Connor brought his guitar. He's going to be a rock star. Michael Sacco, he's not here. His humor sometimes can be a factor.
And queer.
PPRN keeps it real.
hear my music and talk with Neil, keeping you on an even keel. Creepy Bob will behave tonight. No lady guests for him to bite.
Damn it.
Story time, Bob is getting closer. The death pool will make him a poser. PPRN keeps it real. Hear my music and talk with zeal. Keeping you on an even keel. PPRN keeps it real. Humor, music, and talk with zeal. Keeping you on an even keel.
Yeah. Oh, God, yes. Thank you.
Yay.
Well done, Bob.
That was awesome.
Put that compilation together.
Ooh. Well, you know, I'll believe it when I see it.
I know.
That was
75 songs.
75.
It's been a lot of shows.
I know. It's not hard to find either. It's usually within the first half hour, right?
Yeah.
That was that post-analingus burp.
Oh, dude.
Too soon?
Yeah.
Too close. Yeah,
too early.
There's no time for that.
You got to pace yourself, Peter. Come on.
What do you mean? What's wrong with my anus?
No, analingus.
Ew.
Everything. Everything is wrong with your anus.
You've never eaten ass, Eddie?
No, I don't
not
do that.
Once.
No, I don't do that.
Not once.
Wait,
not
someone it. Else's?
The more you ask, the question stays. I'm like, yeah, that one time. No,
never tossed a salad.
Nah, dude.
Missing out, dude.
Dude, wow. Poop comes from there. I ain't fucking with that. Wait. I'm a good Catholic boy. We don't do this shit.
So wow. You have. You're just repressing it.
They're called rim jobs.
On your time.
And Bob invented them in the year 1776.
That's true, guys. If you confess it, it didn't happen.
Should I ask my wife or no?
It's your show.
You don't know the answer, don't.
I don't want to know.
Is this something that could have repercussions? I don't know.
No.
Yeah. If you don't know the answer, don't ask.
That's right.
It's like putting rims on a Toyota. You don't want to do that.
It doesn't add value to either.
No, it doesn't.
Doesn't add value either way.
No.
I don't know. I have a Mitsubishi Mirage. I want to put rims on it.
Do you?
Yeah.
But that's a Mirage, though.
We hate the gays.
I put them on my Saturn.
Yeah, how'd you make out with that?
You put the gays on your Saturn?
No.
Rims. You associate with them.
It's like just married, but it's just covered in the carcasses
of gays.
The gays
got to you with their insidious ways.
Turns out it was the spring on the... I don't know.
So Chris was kind of right.
What?
He's like, he's in the front end. I know it is.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
but he's being stubborn.
Unfortunately, the transmission's in the front end, too.
So it wasn't as expensive as you thought it would be.
No. It was only $522 instead of $1,800.
Ooh.
Well,
that's
it could
a bargain.
Have been $1,800 if it was the transmission.
I'm supposed to be getting mine this week, hopefully.
$1,800 for a tranny. You're overpaying.
Oh, yeah. I get you a whore for 20.
They're like $50 in Bridgeport, right?
Yeah.
It all depends on how much staph infection you're willing to risk.
You don't get staph from hookers.
That's true. Well, it depends if
that's
the trainees. You get the
shaft. Guaranteed to get staph.
Not staph.
Can we just talk about what kind of cars hookers drive?
Oh yeah, we were talking about this. No, because we were talking about this before. She was like, "Hookers,
they don't drive cars. They have someone that picks them up."
Yeah,
Uber.
Their pimp drives the car.
Yeah, Uber.
No, dude, hookers drive Uber. Nice cars. That's just a given thing because they're making. I mean, if you're making that much money, you know, it depends.
What hooker have you seen pull up to your house that hasn't had like a guy with her?
Well, there's just the one that comes every Thursday.
Does she drive?
I call him Mom.
Oh. Wow.
Well, you know his dad's not around.
Oh, yeah, I'm bulletproof on that one. It's my
going for it.
Wow. You got quiet.
Dude,
beat your ass, man.
You know what it is? It's just cold.
That was.
I'm just need like, a jacket?
No, I'm fine. It's getting all the juices flowing in the wrong
it
way.
It is
fucking tree.
Oh.
It's warm over here.
You and that
it's
damn not tree. Fucking cold.
I feel like it's mind over matter with this fucking tropical tree.
You ever notice whoever's like
a fucking tree to get all screwed
up? I'm not freezing because I'm behind a tree.
What's the Rosie O'Donnell one?
Is there a Rosie O'Donnell one on the soundboard?
Is there a Rosie O'Donnell one?
Up. Left.
Oh,
left.
I thought there was like an actual Rosie
O'Donnell.
One of my favorite.
I guess
one of my.
It was nothing.
If you guys, climatic. Have you guys seen the movie Click?
Yeah,
my one of my favorite scenes in the whole movie is Jonah Hill. It's like Jonah Hill's first movie, and he plays his son. And he's all fat.
Yeah, yeah,
he's
yeah.
like, "That's why everyone at school thinks I look like Rosie O'Donnell."
I forgot he was in that, man. That's a great movie.
It's such a. It's so funny because it was like one of his first movies, and he just like. It's so funny that scene. Got the Jufro and everything.
Yeah.
And then he made Breaking Bad. And when,
that was the
awesome.
First movie my oldest daughter cried to, and she was young. Like, we were watching, you know that like, emotional part towards the end when he's, like
in the, dad? In the puddle,
and he's, like, getting rained on. And I'm, like, doing something. I've seen it before. And I hear her, like, kind of, like something's happening. I look over, and she's, like, I don't know, she was, like, sick, and she was, like, boogers and snot.
Oh,
and
yeah.
She was, like, what's happening to me?
What movies have you cried at?
Ooh, that's a good one.
Bob.
I cry easy, man. I
Me
bottle
too.
Up my emotions.
I cry in noon.
Yeah.
I cry when I shouldn't.
I hate when you cry during a commercial because it's so quick. Yeah. Like, why did it have to be so
I
sad?
I cried at the Champ. Do you remember the movie The Champ?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
I cried at the end.
I don't remember the names of the movies that I've seen. So.
That you've cried?
I always try to fight it, too, because like,
yeah,
you never
exactly.
want like, the person. It doesn't matter like how well you know the person, if it's your wife, your girlfriend, or what. You always try to like keep your eyes open and like dry them quick.
You're almost like choke because you try to hold it back.
Yeah. You know what I hate? When it happens in like an all-time like, guy movie, like Rudy. Rudy's one where you watch that with a group of guys.
Yeah, yes.
Dude, you're like.
You cried at Rudy?
It's when they bring the jerseys in and like they
no,
give him the
that
spot.
Part.
That part's insane. But
no,
then also the
part.
Sack, yeah.
When
they
Rudy
hold him
gets
off,
that's when he gets the sack.
Oh, no,
at the
but
end
like
the game,
whole
yeah.
the whole yeah, movie's so
Bob
good.
Bob cried
like,
at the crying game.
I love how you're telling him
Rocky should cry.
Yeah, like, hey, how about
put your cry goggles on.
How about Rocky? Rocky, what was it? Rocky 3 when Mickey died.
I didn't.
I was on the first
tough. That
I was on the brink.
And then the following Rocky IV when Apollo Creed got
I cried
ring.
When I found out how much it made at the box office.
Oh, wow.
At the very end of 50 First Dates, I don't know if any of you have seen that.
Yeah.
That got me.
That got me.
Really?
When they're sailing away on the boat and she wakes up. And then they go through that whole litany on the screen, and then she comes out of the boat and she knows that the kids are there. I mean, it's like, oh, that to me was awesome.
I cried in the beginning of
Game Home and we're having.
I cried in the beginning of Up and got called a homo by a 6-year-old.
What was that?
I was like, that's so sad.
All those movies.
What was that
so
movie
depressing.
With the girls that started a professional baseball league?
A league of their own.
When the guy, from the U.S. military walked into the locker room and gave the said right in front of the team, "I'm sorry, but your husband got killed in the line of duty."
You moron.
Ew.
I remember that. I
just that movie had Rosie O'Donnell that cried every
time
she was
on screen. She was grabbing a hot dog out of the stands. Yeah.
That was when Madonna was still hot.
Yeah.
Oh my
remember
God.
That? I know, right?
May.
She looked really hot.
All the way, May.
You don't think she's hot anymore?
She for 50 something, really? She's pretty good.
I don't know that British accent.
Ooh, I think she's hot still.
Really?
Yeah. What is it? A certain age for you?
No,
what's,
I don't know.
What's
she's
the age
just
limit?
Like.
Women never liked Madonna. That's
no,
the problem.
No, I liked Madonna. I loved Madonna when I was younger.
This might be
was the clothes that she wore.
Women are women's worst critics.
Is there an age limit? Like, and I hate to sound really sexist, but with women, is there an age where, like, officially your penis just goes the other way?
For some,
46.
Well, here's the thing: they'll say that like Helen Mirren's still fucking gorgeous.
Yeah, I think it's
46. Helen
Mirren. No, that's
something. That's something. Yeah, but she's like, I mean,
I heard that, and I didn't know who that
she's
was.
She's still beautiful.
You know, I have feelings. You know,
me too.
I heard that.
I have feelings.
Wait till you have medical issues, and I start all over you. I'm gonna become the horniest person in the world. What's the matter? You
become?
Have, just because they cut your left tit off doesn't mean you can't fuck me.
Wow.
That got
really
weird.
I'm
going to get nasty.
This hour brought to you by Griffin Hospital.
Yeah, but the other tit gets bigger.
It absorbs the power of the other tit.
All she got to do is push one in.
She'll get scoliosis from the unbalance.
Whatever,
she can take one and put it across the whole brow. Look like a whole rack.
I'm a trooper. I've been doing fine.
It's only been a week and a half.
It's a long time.
Wow. Yeah, dude, she's on no dick time. When you're on no dick time.
I
feel like
that's what toys are for.
Peter, you gotta.
Peter,
there's the door.
Peter, that's what toys are for.
Fine.
You know, no, you use them on her.
She's a maniac. She would end up pushing my stomach in.
Wait,
that's a good song.
She's a maniac, dude.
Yeah.
Yeah, I can't risk that.
Yeah, I don't want to hurt him.
You're like
pussy juice all jizzing in the hole.
That didn't sound very convincing.
That might heal it. You never know.
It might.
No.
What do you like mean, the pussy? You don't know.
Zombie apocalypse.
Hey,
I'll turn it to her pussy.
The doctors don't even know if that would work.
Yeah,
when ever does that juice get on your stomach to your side? Whenever does that happen?
When you get on top.
Ride him, cowgirl!
Oh, yeah.
Save a horse, ride a cowboy.
She did a nice way of telling me that she don't come on the bottom.
Yeah?
She's like, I'll get, I got this.
No.
I got this.
Well,
every time, I got it. You relax. I got it. just let me know. Stop.
Just fucking roll over already.
Here you go.
We haven't done a missionary since.
Tea's ready.
The flood of 55.
Wow.
I got
cowgirl style.
I got this. Take it easy. You relax, honey.
Wow. I'm full.
There's nothing normal about our relationship. We're up at 3:30 every day.
Yeah.
Seriously, for the day.
Why 3:30?
3:30.
Because he wakes up and he's just wide awake.
That's
the
still
second
night.
He wakes up.
And she
then
never
he's got to wake me up.
It's technically not night.
And
it's
he's
morning.
Like he's like all happy and chipper, and I'm like fucking half asleep. I'm not a morning.
I'm waiting to hear about Christmas morning in the Pinho household this year. They may not go to bed.
Well, I can't sleep. I get up full. I got more energy than this one, and I get up at 3:30.
What time do you go?
Cocaine's
11:30. Because I have to change the server.
Right,
you had to be. You have like 3 hours of sleep.
Counting on your fingers.
4 hours, yeah.
Three to 4 hours of sleep, and I'm okay.
That's all I used to get when I was younger.
Good thing you don't play with fireworks.
Fuck
you'd be
that.
Terrible.
Dude,
at
I
math.
Need double digits hours.
Yeah,
like or I'm not right.
See, that's the thing. When I partied, I would sleep for fucking hours and hours.
See, I wouldn't go to bed until 1 or 2 in the morning.
I'm on the
and I'd wake
you
up.
You still
at
don't
five.
Go to bed at 1 or 2 in the morning some nights.
Yeah, but now I wake up at noon.
Yeah, there you go.
I'm on the unemployment because
I don't have to get up.
But when he's
that's
sick,
me now.
Though,
oh God.
When what, he's sick, he schedule? Sleeps like all day and all
yeah.
night.
Look, it's when you're like. It's when at like 4:30
my body's
in the afternoon.
Like,
all right, all
right, let's just get some rest.
I am fucking going, man. I'm
I took
wide
a day
awake.
Off from work yesterday. I was bored. How much Price is Right could you watch?
That's where Jerry Springer comes in.
And then I was going to walk to the beach, and it started hurting. So I'm like, I got to turn around. Because I'll end up getting stuck at the beach. No one come get me.
Saltwater's good for a lot of open wounds, too, I heard.
Yeah, saltwater, absolutely.
Hey, go for
yeah,
a swim.
Jump in the sound.
It's,
yeah,
good for, it's good for like acne, poison
between
ivy.
The shit in the water yeah. and the coldness, yeah. I'd be dead.
Like salty water or like ocean water?
Ocean water. Huh. It, you need the whale semen just right.
Peter, have you tried peeing on the staph infection?
No.
Oh.
When he comes next week, I will, though.
All right.
He comes every week.
Oh.
Oh.
They kicked me out of my cardboard box. I had to stay.
They
recycled it.
Yeah. Today was garbage day in Bridgeport. I had to march my house.
Excuse me. You cannot take my house.
Oh, my God. I thought that was Chris.
He's got a nice car, though, surprisingly.
You know, at one point, you've got a nice mobile. At a certain point.
That would be my house.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The car.
I would
well,
have
yeah, but
my car.
I mean, he's got so much stuff in there.
Oh, does he?
We almost had to tie my guitar on the roof.
Oh, to try to get it. How was
oh,
that
wow.
right? How was that right?
He drives very slow.
Oh.
So he's like a Spanish woman.
Yeah. Yeah. It was like. We're on the Merritt Parkway, and he's doing 45, 50.
Oh. Bob's like, I don't got much time. Yeah. Floor it.
The Deadpool is running. Let's
he's
go.
The kind of, he's the kind of guy that you ought to shoot as you go around him, you know?
Does he talk the whole way, too?
Not really.
Oh,
not
wow.
really.
Was it just dead silence?
More or less, yeah.
Was he staring at you?
I can appreciate
it. No.
He was watching the road.
He wasn't concentrating.
And there was somebody who was going slower than him, and he actually passed him.
Were they dead?
Wow.
They were on a scooter.
It was a hospital. It was an ambulance with the sirens not running, showing you somebody was dead in there.
He didn't mention your cock once?
No.
I could see him going.
He didn't
like,
have to. He said
I would love
eyes.
To take advantage.
You can't say cock while you have a cock in your mouth.
I would love to take advantage of this old guy right now.
I said that like a
hey.
What if I put his old cock in my mouth? Would I be able to suck it?
You think it'll get hard?
I'm
trying to suck like 20 years out of him, bring him back to 40
years old. 1388,
Bob's like, I'll suck your dick if we can get there in under an hour.
I'll tell you what, I'll let you suck my dick if you drive a little faster. Yeah.
He goes even slower. He's like, this did not work at all.
You think he stole that truck? you know you had to think about that on the way home. Did he steal this?
What?
Chris. Like, you're in a car. It's a decent car for a homeless guy.
Oh, yeah.
You got to be thinking, did he steal this or are we going to get pulled over?
Well, I think he needed it to get to work, so he bought the car instead of getting an apartment. Yeah. He works in a factory.
Oh, he does? Oh,
wow. Yeah.
I thought he worked in a restaurant, too.
Part-time, yeah.
He's a restaurant factory.
He works at the, was it the,
he's Porter Rexon?
The ejaculation factory.
I'm number 36 at the dildo test factory.
But he's not 37.
He works at the sperm bank.
Yeah, we've decided that's the best job in the world. Is
sexuality, quick, what do you think?
Well,
that's kind of a broad fucking
I think he's
statement.
Bi.
Oh, Chris.
Oh, yeah, Chris.
Yeah.
I think
yeah,
so,
I'm sure.
So?
I'm sure for the right price. Why not? He'll buy whatever you're
what do you
selling.
Mean, a warm couch and a sandwich?
He'll buy whatever you're selling, is what I'm saying.
Give him a pizza, you're all set.
You think he's bi, babe?
No.
Really?
He's like, he's not allowed here anymore. That's she's into it. No.
That's your answer?
That's my answer.
Just said that with some
straight up now.
You got to start talking more. Thursday's coming quick.
Yeah, but when everybody else is talking, I'm not going to over-talk. So.
We just gave you your own shot.
I know, but my answer—that's
no.
That was all I had for.
Because you're too busy eating.
We want some documentation to prove.
Put some food in front of her. That's either a dick or food.
You finished
distracted.
You finished your dinner in the car. I'm still working on mine.
That's part five.
I think he's too young to tell.
Well, I know he's definitely. Definitely
like,
at least
nowadays you can suck dick at 14 and
no, I know, but that's what I'm saying is like you grow out of it though.
No, you don't.
Yeah, at a certain age, you're like I gotta buckle down.
It's not like when we were 14, if we sucked dick, we were shunned.
Yeah, but that's what I'm saying. This generation,
these guys suck dick
what do you
now?
Think happens in high school nowadays?
This generation's gay till graduation.
Now it's like you suck dick, cool. All right,
no, that is not what happens.
No.
Oh, someone went to a private school,
and you didn't go to Orlando school.
I would say it's much more accepting to be homosexual.
Yeah, it is, right?
No. Oh, yeah, that's what I'm saying.
No, I'm not in high school.
But there's a lot of kids though that like at young ages. Hold on, a lot of kids at young ages now, like more than ever, that are experimenting because they're like, I don't know, I like a lot of different things. Whereas, like, before, that didn't happen. And now, as they get older, they're like, you know what? I tried sucking dick. Not a fan. And they just move on. Huh. I don't know. This new generation is different.
No, why? Because Neil Patrick Harris is on TV and Laverne. No, it's still just as stigmatizing the school. Just
I think.
Is it really?
Just because you see it in the mainstream doesn't mean it's not still kids get brutalized for it in high school.
Well, you still have the jocks that are kind of like homophobic.
Anymore?
Yeah, but they're but there's also gay jocks. I mean, they're more open now. Yeah. But there are gay jocks. I'm just saying that.
Would that be a sports?
Yeah, but the basic
target.
Yeah, it's
gay
like
jock?
It's like the pink jersey, the Romo jersey is what it is.
Whoa.
I'm kidding. He's their best cheerleader now.
Their best golfer. That's for sure.
Wait till Thursday. Wait till Sunday.
No, we don't need him right now. We're good.
We're so good. They changed our time slot.
Yeah, I mean, like,
no, this game wasn't changed. The one next week was changed.
Next week, 8:30.
Yeah, but that was a 4 o'clock game. This game was already set for Sunday night before the season even started.
I guess the way it is like with young people, it's a spectrum sexuality. It's not anymore like I'm straight, that's it, or like I'm gay, that's it. It's like a spectrum. Like,
what does me sucking cock? How does that ruin your day?
I think I could chip a tooth. That's what
am I wrong? I mean, well, who
I'm
cares?
Afraid of
Well, that's the thing. That's a good way to look at it, but unfortunately, that's not the way a lot of people look at it. Mm. And yes, there's a lot more people who are more open to explore on a spectrum, but it doesn't change the fact that shitty kids are shitty kids, and most kids are shitty, and therefore...
That's because their parents didn't raise them right.
The thing I'm not a fan of about like teenagers sucking dick is the fact that they take pictures of their meals before they eat it. And I don't need to see that. Like, I don't get that. And the funny thing is, they never cook it. It's never like they made the meal. It's always like... Oh, dude, I went to this barbecue place, dude. It's like, if you made it, I get the pride in taking the picture of it. But, like, when you go somewhere and just order food, like, you're
what's
not doing anything
do
brilliant.
Yeah, he tried to make a joke.
Pictures of your food.
I want to be like, I don't do that. But like,
everybody's like, how'd you go from food to dick?
Yeah, what the hell?
Oh, Ricky.
No, from dick to food.
Dick to food.
And vice versa.
Vice versa. Look, everyone's been homeless at least once.
Ricky went from food to dick.
I got a hot dog today. I almost took a picture of it.
Where?
Wow. What's that place in, Stratford, Riverview? It's over by Sikorsky.
Oh, yeah.
I can't think of the name right
Riverview
now.
Riverview Bistro.
Yeah, that's it. And I'll tell you
all
what.
All right, Bob.
It's called the Honeybee.
Yes.
And it's a hot dog, right, with four giant onion rings, like speared through it. So, like, if you picture the onion rings around a dog. I opened it up, and I was like, wow, I should, like, Instagram that. But I just ate it.
Like an adult.
The temptation was there.
Like a fucking man.
It was beautiful.
I can't even, dude. I did it this weekend. To be fair, it's because there was a lot of food, not because it was
That's
just
because
food.
America makes eating a hot dog sexual.
Yeah,
so you start to get embarrassed.
It's in, it's in Ricky's Spank Bank already.
No, I went on this songwriting retreat this weekend with my roommate. Went to this cabin out in, like, Heath, Massachusetts. And we went to this diner, and I ordered just because I hadn't eaten, like, all day. And we were hiking all day. So I ordered this massive, where it was, like, pancakes, bacon, eggs.
It looked like a shack from Deliverance, by the way.
What? Oh, the house? Oh, yeah. Dude, it's, like, in the middle of nowhere, but it's great. The inside does not look like that at all. It looks fantastic on the inside. But, yeah, I ordered, like, a stupid amount of food. He's like, you're not going to finish that. And then I made a point to it and then cried the whole way home because my stomach was, like, fucking dying. He's like, you shouldn't have let me do it. He's like, I'm not your mom, man. What the fuck?
So you guys were totally, like, away from everything?
Yeah, the stabbing.
I love how you said, not going to have... access to Facebook as you take a picture of it.
I had Wi-Fi. Yeah, no, I had Wi-Fi here and there. So like, I took that and then waited a while and then I posted the picture later on. Okay. Yeah,
that's okay. It was the last house with Wi-Fi.
Dude, there's nothing around for fucking miles except for the Vermont border. We walked from Massachusetts to Vermont and it took us only 5 minutes.
If someone came up to you and said, "You could be two things right now. You could be off Facebook eternally, or you have to be gay." What would you pick?
Wait, what are the
that?
I don't understand how either of those work right
I'm saying,
the way you said it. Because
you're addicted to both.
What do you mean Facebook eternally?
You either have to be like, on Facebook forever.
Hold on.
Eternally.
Oh,
you can never go back on it.
Oh, okay. So I'm banned from it.
Yes.
But you have to live off cock. You made it sound like my consciousness was downloaded onto Facebook, which is really weird.
You're off eternally. That's it. No more. Or you got to suck cock. Or you got to be gay.
I don't know. I don't really need Facebook.
Homophobe.
No, I mean, like,
you're so proud of yourself, too. Like, homophobe.
You know what?
I'm better than him.
I can't be without Facebook. You're crazy.
Well, how am I supposed to get men without Facebook?
Go to Orlando.
Leave Orlando out of this.
What about you, Bob?
What?
Facebook? Oh, you can get rid of Facebook. You're old, yeah.
But he can't drop the dick.
Which one would you be, Facebook or dick?
It's such a weird question.
You really can't decide.
I can't remember shit.
All right, so you would suck dick because you wouldn't remember.
That's He'd right. like sign on to Facebook. Ah, oh, shit! Now I gotta suck a penis. Oh man,
you would be gay because you wouldn't remember being gay.
That's right.
You blew me last night. Okay.
Did you say so?
You say
I'll
so.
I'll take your word for it.
Was it good?
Guess it wasn't that good because I don't remember it.
That's right. Couldn't have been any good or I would have remembered it. Yeah.
Oh, that's where I got the staff.
Ooh.
What about you, Eugene?
Wait. Whoa. We were talking about
We know what you would do.
Dicks. And then, no. We were talking about dicks and you go, oh, that's where I got the staff. In fact, what the fuck?
This summer, I went an entire month without using my cell phone and I just forgot about it. I didn't miss it. So
Facebook.
Yeah. Wait, what?
So you would either be gay or off Facebook forever.
Can I take both?
I like that.
Well,
because no, he's torn.
If
fairness,
you take the gay, then you're supposed to be on Facebook.
He's torn between his passive aggressive behavior toward Facebook and his love for cock.
Yeah, because it's like LGBT community in Facebook.
Can I be like bi, but I just stop using Twitter?
We know what you would take.
You're off Instagram.
You're not allowed to use anything that's
so
too
you
close
would
to
go
the
with
twat.
The cock or you would go with the Facebook?
I don't think I understand the question. So
yeah,
like,
it's not a real
you have to
like,
you have to lose Facebook.
He just wants
you have to
say
lose
like,
Facebook,
but then you have to switch your sexuality.
No, you're straight. No.
You say lose Facebook, stay straight. Suck cock and not have Facebook.
No.
Well, I mean, that's what I meant.
That's what I meant.
Doesn't make sense.
That's not how it works, Peter.
So I've been doing
this. This isn't the land of Peter Pinho,
dude. Facebook made me gay. Facebook made me so gay.
Oh, God.
I used to love her.
You can suck cock, but you can't be on Facebook. Or you can be on Facebook and suck cock.
Could I keep Instagram?
That's the same thing.
That's the same thing.
That is the same thing.
Okay.
Yeah. So, yeah, it is.
So I've been doing this show for like what, like a month now, and it just seems like every show is you trying to get dudes to admit that they would suck dick. Like that's every show.
That's
I'm not saying wrong. I'm just saying it just seems like every episode is like, how can I get them to?
Because I walk by a fucking pack of homophobes all day.
I feel like one day there's gonna.
I
want
to get someone to admit it one day, like Bob did.
One day there's gonna be like a Peter version of Saw where he makes all these scenarios happen, and he's just got his dick behind a wall after the staff infection.
That was the picture he put on the staff thing on Facebook.
The anecdote is in my dick, or you have to go on. You can't use Facebook anymore.
If Bob was supposed to die right now, but you had to blow me, so he would live, would you do it?
It's no.
Would you save Bob?
I'm not gonna. I don't want to do it for a summer rental. Like if he was younger, maybe. No offense, Bob.
Yeah,
I like, there's a good chance you died mid blowjob.
True.
Man, it'd be the beginning.
On the downstroke.
He's right. He's right.
Oh, I almost threw up. What the fuck?
It's almost like a waste of a blowjob.
That's right.
You would need almost
and
like
this
a defibrillator.
This is where Mickey dies in Rocky.
Oh.
You would need a defibrillator just to make sure he's still alive when you were done.
I think it would be
yeah,
really
yeah,
all right,
so Bob
be.
Dies in the middle of it. Do you swallow?
If he dies in the middle of it, how's he gonna finish? Wow.
I feel like there's no way you're like, yeah, but I didn't swallow.
You're like,
all
right, fuck it, he's dead.
No, if Bob's dead and he finishes, it's not what you want it to be.
That'll be pissy. I'll be mad about that. If I just swallowed something, he's still dead.
Yeah, but I think the swallowing though, I don't know, I feel like
that load and your ashes are going in the same urn.
Yeah, but I would say this, that it's not like I'd start a business like sucking dick for life or something like that. So it's like a one-time thing, right?
It'd be one hell of a funeral.
So it's like if I'm going to, I'm going to swallow, because here's why.
Oh, Jesus.
Here's why. Because it's not like it's any less gay. You can't be like, oh, but I didn't swallow, dude. Like, it's
he's not wrong, yeah.
It's not like you could be like, you dude,
I think
dude
we're
bro.
Starting to find out who the homophobe is not.
I just want to know one thing.
What is it with the goddamn tree? Whoever sits in this tree just gets into a freaking mode.
What does that even
Kathleen
mean?
Kathleen sat there last week. She got into a mode. Sackle sits there. He's in a mode. You're in rare form tonight.
I know. It's what? Like I'm a Dak Prescott.
No, you're not a Dak. No, it's like whoever sits in the tree just takes it to a different level.
Well, has anyone here ever tasted semen for real?
Wait, even if it's your own?
Even
Ricky's,
if it's your own.
Ricky's like, do I say that?
Come on, nobody took a lick.
Peter's just like,
I just am not good at washing my hands.
By mistake.
How the fuck do you buy mistake?
By mistake.
He's
because
not
when I was younger,
hand.
I used to try to blow loads in my face. But
wait, yeah,
that's not a mistake. Then you were trying to blow loads in your face.
No, I wasn't trying to.
Yeah,
swallow.
A tube connected from your wang to your mouth is not a mistake.
That's
you did that.
That's
on
a straight bypass.
When I was younger,
it's
I used
like
to
a straw.
No.
When I was younger, I used to be able to shoot over my head.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's impressive.
Yeah.
Yeah. So
now it just drips out.
Sad. It actually makes the sound. Wah, wah.
And then it got in my eye too. That hurt. It burned in the eye.
Yeah. You want to shoot a good load, you know, and you want to see a good load too.
Are you giving tips on this now?
Well, like, do you ever watch a porno and then you get to the end and just not? It's just like it kind
whoever
of
gets to an end of a porno.
Like,
most people, because they don't use the same tape every time.
Well, I don't get through the credits.
Well, you know,
so
you
want to
like, you want to time it right. You want to like, you know,
you want to come simultaneously
with the
like,
with
during
the
money
actors.
Shot. Yeah, yeah, you want to hit it right at the money shot.
Oh yeah, you got to like do the money shot when one of them's coming.
Anyway, when it just drips out, it's just anticlimactic. You want to see a good.
Especially when he's like going for it, and he's like, yeah, like he's the toughest shit in the world, and then it's just like,
it's why one of the keys.
You ever feel bad when there's a girl that
velocity.
She's like really young? And there's a guy standing over her, and he's just blowing the biggest load on her face. Do you ever just want to jump in the movie and go, come on, honey, you don't need this.
Like, that
you're
is
too
so,
good for this.
That is someone's daughter, sir.
Yeah.
You ever, yeah. Do you guys ever get in trouble based on, like, your illiteracy? For, like I was going through porn. I'm just like, oh, she's wicked hot. You watch it. It's like POV. And then, like, midway through, she's just like, yeah, daddy. And you're like, what the fuck? And then you read it, it's like stepdaughters and shit. You're like, this is fucked up.
Yeah, there's a lot of stepdaughters.
Why is that a thing? Why are dudes in like into like the whole stepdad, daughter?
No, it's no not with stepbrother man. And stepsister.
That's even worse.
It's stepmothers.
Some of them it's not even step. Like there's no step.
You're right. Oh yeah, like
they just dive into
dad
it.
Dad would
you're
be
like,
mad
this
if
fucked.
He knew.
Like,
some
how much
shit.
Porn are they watching in the flyover states that it's like, oh yeah, I want to watch somebody fuck their relative.
The creepiest part is when they're like, don't tell mom.
Yeah.
That's like the, when you're in the middle of it, you're like, oh.
Or when she goes, don't tell your father and it's her mother.
Yeah,
exactly. Anytime they bring it back to like family, because you're like, oh, they're having sex. And then they say shit and it reminds you that they're supposed to be related. Then it's weird again.
Not going to lie, twin lesbians are dope.
Peter, Bob, remember back in the day?
Double standard,
porn,
dude.
There was like three categories. I mean, right nowadays, there's how many categories?
Too
are
many.
There?
It's teen, because computer Asian people teen. Are on a spectrum.
There was Ovaltine.
Grandmothers.
Did you say Ovaltine?
Yeah.
Bridgeport girls from the east, Bridgeport girls from the south.
Remember when anal was a new thing in the porn industry?
Bob does.
You're like, anal, what?
You can do that?
You're like, I didn't even know.
Was there anal when you were younger? Like,
yeah.
I mean, porn?
It wasn't new. It's not new.
Porn was when you were younger, like 20, 15,
It's called
16?
Catholicism.
Yeah. When did they invent porn?
Yeah. 70s, right?
No, he was like 30.
Before that.
But that was like a quad X. You had to really hunt to find that kind of shit.
Yeah, that was like
it's in
like
the rental VHS shop.
That was under Kinky, probably back. Yeah, like, that was like a Kinky. You have to go go in the back room of the back room.
You need Jesus.
Yeah,
back you watch that Devil's movie. You need Jesus.
I remember going into the first time I went to like the porn store. Like I was in there for like ever. There were so many sections.
I still won't go into porn.
So many things, and like I thought I saw. I think I ran into a friend of mine's dad, and it got so awkward.
Oh God!
Me and Ricky went to VIP. I couldn't go in.
Wait, why the fuck are you in the porn store?
This was like
that's
what,
creepy.
VIP
man.
Isn't is that a
this was
like
13
like a,
years
that's
ago.
A porn
this
store.
There is
yeah,
internet
not
porn
really.
Back.
You
they
can buy
toys.
You try getting you try like watching porn in like 2002. It's not fun.
You
like
can,
the buffering.
You can buy underwear and stuff there. Like
yeah, that's like a classier store.
But
you're talking about like those
no,
stores,
like the store that just sells
like the bodega, like the ones that smell like bleach.
Maybe
yeah.
There was one I went to. It had
the
longest hallway
back.
Ever. And the guy behind the counter had like a bulletproof glass. And he's like, let me check your ID. Because it was like my birthday was like a week earlier. And he's like, you didn't waste much time, did you? And I was like,
Yeah, when the guy behind the counter starts talking to you, it's creepy.
Yeah, and like he just sits there and just watches me like I'm going to steal something. But I'm freaking the fuck out. And I'm just staring at a wall. Like my eyes are blurry. I'm like nervous as fuck. I'm like a good kid. I'm like, and then I'm just sitting there and I've been staring at this one wall, like picking up things, just like pretending he's not looking anymore, but he's still looking at me. And then I look and it's like trannies. It's like, that's all I was looking at. So I was like, no wonder this guy was looking at me. I looked at it. It was like barely female. And I just dropped the DVD and ran out of
there.
Get
out of there at that
point. Yeah, caught on the copy of Boy Butts Make Me Go Nuts.
I was like, this is awkward.
How about funny? What?
He didn't send you to visit the booth?
Oh. No.
How about funny porn names? I heard a few today.
Where?
Yeah.
On the radio.
Oh.
Like, what
was it
the
just
one
now?
What did I
like
text
what?
You?
The lost direct deposit.
Oh, direct deposit. The other one.
That's a good one.
The other one.
Something
Lone
load.
Or something?
The load ranger.
The load ranger.
Oh, that's a good one.
The load ranger. Yeah. I like Shaving Ryan's Privates.
Well, that's porn titles. That's
pretty good. Porn names. Yeah.
That's what you're saying. It's not saying porn stars. It's saying porn names.
Yeah.
Oh,
movie
okay.
Load ranger.
Oh, I got you.
Jesus Christ.
They turn movies into porn names.
Yeah, you could, like name a movie. Let's do it. Just name any movie. We'll do
name
it.
Name a movie and we'll do a porn name to it.
Or get the greatest movies of all time and we'll just go through it. Get a list. All
right, I'll get a list of it.
Like the Shawshank Redemption.
There you go. That's damn, good. What would you call Good Morning Vietnam then?
Good Morning Vagina.
Nah.
What's that kind of
like? Good Morning Wood Vietnam.
Good
like
morning, electric car.
Well, you're being very self-centered over there now.
Instead of Gladiator.
That's what happens. There we go. That's what happens when it gets
Zootopia.
Pootopia.
Oh.
Fecophilia.
Nice.
You could have said Boobtopia, dude. What the fuck? Right. Why are you going to shit the poop?
Hell or high water?
Hell or guy water?
Hell or guy hotter?
Moonlight.
Boob light.
Yes.
You already know
Dennis, keep rolling with it.
The Jungle Book.
The Bunghole Book.
The Bungholio Book.
How about the Bushy Jungle Book?
Yes.
Yeah, I like that too. Or the Jungle Fever Book.
The Janet Jackson Book. Love and Friendship.
Lust and Friendship.
Oh, aren't you just fucking so proud tame you are.
Long and Friendly.
You're like softcore fancy porno.
Finding Dory.
Finding Glory.
Finding
Glory. Barry.
Finding Glory Hole. Yeah. Arrival.
Anal.
Arrival.
Help.
Ricky.
Anal.
Hump for the wilder people.
Ooh.
Cunt for the wilder people.
That's a slow pitch.
No.
Hey, hump for the wilder people.
Yeah.
Kubo and two strings.
That's enough right there.
Kubo and G strings.
That's a porno, dude.
No, that's enough right there.
Period and strings.
Kubo and G strings.
Captain America Civil War.
Cocktown America.
Civil whore.
Civil whore.
Yeah, there you go.
Civil's.
That was a team effort there.
Boosh.
Captain America was Civil the whore. Mad Max Fury Road.
We don't need to name that one.
That one's already there.
Inside Out.
Don't need to change that one.
Put it in, take it out.
Selma. Salsa.
Semen? I don't fucking know.
Selma? Selfie.
Well, it's like how the gladiator, this one is real. The gladiator pair is called Glad He Ate Her.
Yeah.
There you go.
Spotlight.
That's good.
Cocklight.
Titlight.
Star Wars Spotlight. The Force Awakens.
Star Wars. Star Wars The Fork Awakens. The Pork Awakens.
Brooklyn.
Brooklyn.
That's the name of a whore.
Low credit score.
That's my ex-wife's name.
It follows your chin.
It swallows.
Dick swallows.
Yes.
I'm Ahmed in the sheep movie. No, Sean in the sheep movie. What men do with sheep movie.
It's like, because now we're not picturing Dong in the sheep movie. The movie itself.
What men do with sheep movie?
Dong in the sheep movie.
The Martian.
The slut. I don't know.
Oh, boy.
I don't know.
I'm like trying to come up with rhymes. It's not working.
No, this is tough.
Room?
Room?
Boom?
Room? I don't know.
Boom?
Boyhood.
Yeah. Girl.
Pedophile.
Boy's hood.
Girl's hood.
The boy that licked
hood? Uncircumcised.
Or toy hood. Hi, Ricky.
Babadook.
Babadook.
No.
Oh. That one's good. Just leave it.
Yeah, leave that one alone.
Babadook the hanging clip.
Help!
Mr. Turner.
Mrs. Turner.
It would be an all anal movie?
Yeah, Mrs. Turner.
Mrs. Turner. The Lego movie?
Mrs.
The Vice.
Oh, the square in the hole peg movie. When you were a kid, you're trying to put the square
in
the hole.
No, it's the Leg Ho movie. Oh. Leg Ho.
Life itself.
Whiplash is a good name.
Whiplash would be a blowjob movie.
A lot of these just kind of stand on their own. It's weird.
Nightcrawler would be a black pizza delivery guy.
Or Bueno.
Leviathan. I don't know.
Leviathan.
Leviathan. Gloria would be an old 70s disco girl. I don't know.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Gloria.
He's just getting weirder.
Snowpiercer.
Ooh.
Hope Piercer,
yes.
He only rapes white little girls. Like,
Why is it going to be little girls?
Because it's snow and he's piercing her.
Yeah, but why does snow have to be little girls? Like,
why
it's
is
like
it little? Why
camera person. The guy behind the movie.
It's POV.
Never
oh, that would be
movies.
Like a...
That's plenty of fish.
That would be like a biography on what the guy behind the camera does. Things to come.
We got to change come to come.
Tower would be a big black guy's cock. In a movie.
Yeah, tower power.
The power of tower.
The only tower standing in Ground Zero.
Oh.
Moonlight. He banks chicks all at the bottom of the old towers. Moonlight.
Boob light.
We already did that one.
Yeah. I think we already did that one. Yeah. We already did
Manchester
that one.
By the sea. You would have people with two teeth.
Man's chest hair by the
Cake
sea.
Cake by the ocean.
Nice.
That's pretty good.
The love bitch.
And moan.
The love Mona. Bitch.
Yes means no.
I've never heard of like most of these movies. How are these the best
movies? I know. These are the best movies. Go,
I'm
going to
go home
top
and watch
grade.
Kubo and Two
Strings. We might just watch Debbie Does Dallas.
You can always extend the names too. Like, Don't Breathe, I Have a Pillow Over Your Face.
Or Don't
I
Breathe.
I got something
you
else on her face.
Works. Ricky, what is he doing?
Nothing. I don't know. I don't know where this is coming from.
Be happy because clearly there's some shit going on in his brain.
Just make sure you don't have Cake by the Ocean.
Pay some bills.
Who doesn't want Cake by the Ocean?
We'll be right back.
Sex works.
J&M Automotive in Norton, Connecticut has been in business for 28 years. They stock over 450 quality pre-owned cars. They have the highest quality cars with haggle-free price, complete financing for all credit scores. They take all traders. They are rated with the Better Business Bureau AAA. They were voted CTI ADA Quality Dealer of the Year. Visit jnmautomotive.com for cars, pics, videos, and descriptions. jnmautomotive.com. They're located in Naugatuck on 756 and 820
New Haven Road with over 250 cars in the lot. Call them at 203-723-5666. That's 203-723-5666. Also, go check them out on New Haven Road and check out their website, jnmautomotive.com. And tell them PPRN sent you.
Hi there, and if you need any kind of work done to your car, you can try DeSilva's Auto Body, located in Naugatuck at 275 Rubber Avenue. Serving the Naugatuck Valley community with the highest quality of craftsmanship for 25 years, we pride ourselves in delivering on our promise of extraordinary customer service and product satisfaction. We have recently expanded our business with in-house experts and industry gold standard equipment. So once again, give us a call at DeSilva's Auto Body, 203-729-5967. That's 203-729-5967, located in Naugatuck on Rubber Avenue. Once again, the Silva's Auto Body, 203-729-5967.
You're listening to PPRN, motherfucker. It's Doobie from Whipsnap, and you're listening to PPRN, you fucking wanker.
Did you just hear how bad that sounded? Well, you won't get that sound at Hat City Music Productions, located at 536 Federal Road in Brookfield. CEO Chris Litwin takes your music to the next level. If you're tired of those basement recordings, those people that you pay too much money for and have you get out within a half hour, well, you won't have that problem. Hat City Music Productions, once again located at 536 Federal Road in Brookfield. Go check out Hat City Music Productions. You won't be disappointed. Tell them PPRN sent you. Ah, fuck!
It's Doobie from Whipsnap, and you're listening to PPRN, you fucking wanker.
It's Dewey from Whitesnap, and you're listening to PPRN, you fucking wanker.
Honey, why you calling me so late? It's kinda hard to talk right now. Honey, why you crying? Is everything okay? I gotta whisper cause I can't be too loud. Oh well, my girl's in the next room. Sometimes I wish she was you. I guess we never really moved on. It's really good to hear your voice saying my name. It sounds so sweet coming from the lips of an angel. Hearing those words, it makes me weak. Love, don't never wanna say. Talking to me, will it start a fight? No, I don't think she has a clue. Well, my girl's in the next room. Sometimes I wish she was you. I guess we never really moved on. It's really good to hear your voice say my name. It sounds so sweet coming from the lips of an angel. Hearing those words, it makes me weak. Don't never wanna say goodbye, but girl, you make it hard to be faithful with the lips of an angel.
PPRN Radio, Instagram, Facebook. Huh?
Can I go up a little bit?
What?
I can't hear myself that good.
There you go.
Because the music's
flowing.
Oh,
your chord. I love Creed.
Great song. Yep.
All right, cool.
Which
cool,
one's
cool.
Mine?
Just follow your chord.
There we go.
And he man.
Oh.
Damn it.
Is this guy still crazy?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Nuttier than ever.
He's still in the same hotel room from like 3 years ago.
What, didn't they find him like with a in plan a hotel to assassinate room. The president?
What? Really? What?
Yeah, he like had
he was on a whole bunch of drugs.
That
dude.
Shit crazy.
All I know is he was supposed to play in Connecticut, and my buddies in 30th of February were supposed to open for him. He had a fucking meltdown, and they had to cancel the show. They were supposed to open
that's
the Webster.
That's right, yeah.
He was going to play the Webster.
Yeah, they, that's what the government wants.
They promoted for like 4 months, and they were like stoked for it, and yeah, it fell apart.
If you believe the mainstream media.
The lamestream media.
Very true.
Can you take me higher?
Good tunes.
So
it is a great song.
To a place where you everybody forgot the words after higher.
wait,
you're fired.
I love how Dennis is just disappearing more and more into the tree.
He looks like a fucking Pokemon. Look at him.
He's pulling a Socko.
Pokemon.
How does someone of your caliber and size? 14
to 15 more times. I'm out of here. All right.
I'm telling you. 14 to 15 more times.
All right, Eugene. We forgot about you in the first hour. Let's get some music out of you, huh?
Oh, that is balling.
Let's turn off Cree.
Turn up the guitar.
Turn up that guitar.
I like how Bob's singing.
Oh, there.
Eugene Gallagher, hit it up, baby.
So, this song is about being in love, right?
Yeah.
Woo.
It's actually about putting it all out there and falling flat on your face. It's called Then You Listen to Me. I didn't know I was in the wrong. I thought that I was being strong for me and you strong for me and who I thought you were. I thought you swore you were in love. Guess that was worthless like my words were. I used toward your freedom from what you swear you wanted and you listened to me. I dealt with this fray the best and only way that I see fit, that I know. How can I put you away? How can I see light of day and not be reminded of what I believe to be love? What I need to be love, and it needs to be us, cause it hurts way too much, and it's much to withstand. Sieve and expand, sieve and expand, sieve and exactly what my version of hell would be like. And you listen to me. And I'm going right into it. One of my favorite things about playing
penis?
Songs in drop D. Actually, I am talking about D. I'm talking about drop D.
Drop D.
Nuts in my mouth.
It sounds so good.
Gurgle, gurgle.
So thanks a lot for having me on.
It's our pleasure.
It's always so much fun to come here. The conversation is always so colorful.
It is.
Yeah.
This song is a story in three verses. The first verse is about all of those relationships you have that just kind of waste your time. All of those one-night stands, two-night stands. You've been one-nighted before, right?
Oh, yeah.
Ruh-roh.
That's how he got a bad heart.
And the death pool begins.
That's the last time I passed my mind up for what wasn't good enough. To begin with, I've been with one or two And I finish before you, that's my MO. Time to go, wine will flow, then I will show you out the door. Shirts hit the floor, hurts if ignored. Worse when it's my word up against yours. In this next verse, I'm thrown into, you guys, I had kids early, right? I'm 36 years old, and I have a, I've got a 15-year-old daughter. That's crazy. So when I was like 23, I was in it.
Yeah.
You know, home, all that shit.
I can relate to that.
Yeah, it was scary, you know? Catapulted to the forefront of middle class, little lass of your past self, your last leg, your bad health. Why would you spend the who, what, where, and why of the rest of your life behind doors, behind desks, writing checks with blue inks? Who do you think that you are, that you are? You've come far, but you're not even remotely close to where you want to be. Don't you see that this life is a pigeonhole you've climbed through? Now it's up to just you to crush through all of this resistance. Please resist what you think existence is, because it's not even close. Leaving most to believe in a ghost someone dreamed in their mind for a reason to rape and kill and blind. You may find it hard inside this box or this cross. It's harmless, but a cause that is lost. It's harmless. Thank you so much. I'm playing a show at Cafe 9, December 12th, with a lot of cool bands, and it's a Monday.
Yep.
So
nice.
I hope to see some people there. I'm Eugene.
Yeah.
Thank you.
How do you make your voice sound like you're crying?
I really
about the conversation you had here tonight.
I suppress my emotions, and so that's why I cry at like long distance commercials. And
do
like,
you? He was thinking about Click the whole time he was singing. That's why he was like.
It's actually rare when I get to just play the guitar and sing, because I've taken my live set to like a weird place with like effects and loopers, and my on stage I have 7 synthesizers.
Right.
So I've gotten away from this, and I think I'm going to start like getting back into it, you know,
because it's cool.
It's fun, you know, just to have the guitar. And actually, when I show up for a gig, it takes me like a half hour to set up. So it's like,
yeah,
it's ridiculous.
Yeah.
So that's, yeah.
I was like, I can't wait that long. Half hour. Fuck that. He's like, I'm in and out. Bob's not listening. It's cool.
I was listening.
That was the first time I've ever seen anybody of Bob's age get distracted.
By a
phone.
Yeah, what's up with that there?
What? Fuck you guys.
Yeah, what's going on with that, bro?
I was checking something.
He wasn't even using it.
Were you checking your
phone.
Life expectancy?
Yeah,
or?
Yeah. Actually.
Saw plenty of fish.
What are the odds on a daily basis?
What do you have an app called? The defibrillator?
Yeah.
Does it keep your heart going?
Yeah.
Hey, I got a question for you. I saw in the middle of when you were going from one harmonica to another.
Yeah.
What's the difference in them? I mean.
That's a good question. It's the key. Like, this is in the key of C.
Okay.
So, like, if I played, and this is a song in D, so if I played that, it would just
it would not sound
right. Right, right.
Yeah,
just,
you got time for one more?
I just found it interesting. In the middle, yeah, sure. I found it interesting. In the middle of the song, he went from one
to
the other.
No, no, he did. It was... He was transitioning from one song to a second
song.
But
it was right in the middle. He just did it right there. I mean, just that's impressive.
Good call on the harmonica.
Let's do
too.
One more.
I love harmonica so much. Yeah.
I'm going to try.
And this is the A.
I'm going to play one of my my favorite songs of mine. That
I Live With a Bitch?
It's
No, that's your diary.
Wow.
Wow. Hopefully this song doesn't
betray me. On WTNH at 11 o'clock.
It's called Staph Infection. Coming to you live.
That's my new porn, Staph Infection.
No, it's Shaft Infection.
That's a good one.
Or Shaft Infection.
Yeah, that's a new porn movie, Shaft Infection.
Okay. He's starting the song here.
Exactly.
I got the rest of my body to rip apart with Bacardi, Jack Daniel, Hennessy, whiskey, so it's dripping from me. I'm called a cabinet killer, refrigerator to freezer. I know a habit that's really gonna kill me. I get a better feeling with this medicine, girl. Swirl, spinning women like I'm watching the world twirl. Spitting up on everything in the room with her. Everything inside of me. Identifying with my demons and gods. Devil speaking to us to like an even the odds. Even people with no reason at all, they're really gonna like me. Every morning is a miracle, man. If I can open my eyes, stand, I realize I'm damned. I won't jump out the window where I land. They won't identify me. I got the rest of my body to rip apart with Bacardi, Jack Daniel, Hennessy, whiskey till it's dripping from me. I'm called the cabinet killer, refrigerator to freezer. I know a habit that's really gonna kill me. With the power that God allotted me to see how cowardly I can be, and I can be so unbelievably cowardly. Easy does it, the reason it wasn't in the budget. Who me, I love it, used to rub it and even covet and call her nice names. Well, now it's back to plan B, blackening my sympathy. I can't have you if I got me. I'm so sorry, I'm sorry, I'm sorry. Oh, 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 oh. I'm called the cabinet killer, refrigerator to freezer. I know a habit that's really gonna kill me.
I'm called the vagina killer.
Dude, that was awesome.
That was awesome.
Hell that was sick. That was good.
Good.
Thank you.
Real good.
Thank you.
Yeah, that was all right.
The Jello wasn't bad either.
Where did we meet you?
When?
Santos. Where?
At that open
Santos.
Mic.
Yeah. Santos at the open mic. Yeah.
Yeah. Ooh. And my life has never been the same.
Yes, it has. I like that little poster you made. You should have did that shirtless today, though. Girls usually make the posters and then put them on their body somewhere. That was cool what you did, though.
Yeah. I like, for some reason, whenever I, not that I go on the radio a lot, but for some reason, I just always do a poster.
Yeah, I see that.
That's good.
I see that.
Yeah, it's fun.
Hopefully you don't have too many posters on your wall.
My daughter helped me with that when she scribbled all over it. And I was like, no! And I was like, okay, it doesn't
look
too bad.
How old's your daughter?
Two.
Oh.
She's acceptable.
Yeah.
For sitting there, I thought it was the 15-year-old. I'm like, you got to.
Yeah. I have, like, too many daughters.
That's the name of an album.
You have three kids?
Too many.
Don't daughters. You love little baby smell?
Babies are amazing.
Yeah.
But it's funny because.
Babies and puppies.
They grow up, you know.
Yeah. Babies and puppies.
Yeah.
And the older
especially
they
puppies.
Get, the girls, the older they get, the harder they are to manage.
Oh, my God. Oh, don't even go God. There, please.
And the more you have to keep them away from Uncle Bob.
That's right.
Yeah. It's
wow.
Well, hey, look. With Uncle Bob, he's just going to look. You don't know about the other ones out there. They're going to touch.
Yeah, but one day your heart just might do a reverse, and then you're going to just start.
Yeah, well, I get what you guys are saying now, because my daughter's a senior in high school, and you know what? Keeping the boys away from her, because she's such a. My daughter's such a.
No. You can't say it on the radio, but.
No, my daughter is such a beautiful girl. She really is, but.
Yeah.
Keeping the teenage boys, yeah. And even now with her at 17, keeping the 18, 19, and 20-year-old boys away from her. It's
oh,
like,
yeah.
It's like, hey. Hey, if you ain't ready for that.
If you haven't taught her by now.
Oh,
Bob's going to teach her.
Oh, I ain't. The mama should have had to talk. The mama has to talk with the girls. The dad has to talk with the boys.
I don't know anything about that.
Get ready to go.
Otherwise, it's really awkward. Like, I have questions. Or, like, I can't help.
See, I got to answer both. My dad, you know, dad's not around. I'm the oldest of 10 kids, and, you know, they all come to me because I'm the big brother.
Right.
My sister just started her first semester of college at Ithaca in New York. She's going to hate me for bringing that up.
That's all right, but you know what? She's in college.
She gets embarrassed
different.
Of everything. She's ridiculous. She's at that age where everything embarrasses her. Yep. But I'm terrified.
So at that age, she's in college.
Yeah. Well,
exactly.
That's yeah. So embarrassing, dude.
I'm just terrified because like now yeah. She's like 6 hours away in New York, and like there's nothing I can do. Like I can't.
Where is she in New York?
Up in Ithaca, up toward upstate, right?
Yeah, it's way, way
up towards here. Just a little bit past.
What's the name of the college?
Yeah. Ithaca.
Ithaca.
Is that where Haley goes?
No.
It's a Division III college.
Yeah.
I don't remember the name of Haley's college.
Well, she's just going for architecture. She's not.
You mean the true amateur athletes?
The very, very.
The guys who would have gone pro except for that bum knee.
You know, that's kind of like a slap to the face when you get a scholarship for sports and it's like a
it's
really
I'm
making
you laugh. You're crappy college.
Yeah. Look, when you get a scholarship,
you guys know what I did? You guys know what I did this past Saturday? I went with my girlfriend. Over to Bryant University because she's a sophomore at Watertown High, and she's
always the loudest one at all.
No, she participated in a college showcase for lacrosse. I mean, they had Bryant University, UConn, Holy
That's
Cross.
Everyone's mouth is usually full of your wife's box.
Yeah, but they were all lesbians. But I mean, you got Division I and Division II schools looking at these 50 people
yeah.
over to school in Rhode Island, and they had some athletes. That came from as far as Michigan out to this.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, I mean, just Division I, Division II is so much higher than
yeah.
Ithaca well, Division III.
I think if you're a Division III athlete, though, the nice thing is like, you're there for school, you know what I mean? It's like
yeah.
you get the
yeah,
ride.
There's
exactly.
Scholarship. There's no scholarship.
No, there's no scholarship. Oh, there's no scholarship. There, but if okay. you're Division One, if you're Division One and you get
yeah,
a scholarship, you're
a professional athlete.
Yeah,
exactly.
You're on
okay?
the Can I talk to you for just a second?
No.
We went by some fraternities the other day that looked like actual fraternities from, like, Animal House.
Oh, yeah? Did they have, like, frat row? Like,
they were
all
downtown
the
New Haven by the bar.
Oh, oh
yeah. I know what you're talking about.
I said to Ricky, I said, there's got to be somebody that got raped in one of these houses.
I stole beer
At
from
least.
One of those houses.
I feel like that's
You've seen
like,
them, right?
I stole beer from one of them.
Dude, they got extension cords coming
and you
out
didn't
of
give
the
me
mail
any?
Slot.
You we were walking down the street. We were drunk coming back with three sheets. They're all, like, they got cases piled up out in front of the house.
You come out of the bar. If you come out of the bar's entrance, you take a left, go by that Mexican restaurant,
yes.
take a quick right. There's a yep. side street.
There. Yeah, yeah.
Wow.
Oh, cool.
Yeah.
And there's like five, like, I don't know the Omega signs, but.
Yeah. They've got them.
One's yeah. got like a mattress that's out in the middle of the yard. One's got like an electrical cord coming through the mail slot.
That's where Bueno was sleeping.
Animal
I said, Ricky, I said, somebody got raped in one of these houses.
Either it's
or
all just
like
them. Greek restaurants or frats.
Yes.
You can't tell the difference.
Dude, they're frats. You can tell.
Dude, that fraternity had great breadsticks.
It must be for Yale, though, right?
Yeah. It's for Yale.
I don't know Yale had cool fraternities.
They
oh,
don't.
Yeah.
They're like, they
oh,
have
really?
A couple. They're like, my girlfriend went to Yale, and she says they're all right, but they're not like, you know, like what you think of when you think of frats. Like, they throw parties, but she said they're all kind of lame.
It's like, come for the hummus, leave for the,
yeah.
the rape.
Yeah.
Stay for the rape.
They're too intellectual
it's
for us.
It's not rape when we're all high-priced lawyers after 5 years.
Well, if you can swim, all's forgiven.
Like, I think it was like our third date.
No, Yale's basketball team's pretty good.
It's all right.
Why is it got to be about race?
Yeah, why is there any sports?
Yeah,
no, it's just, it just, it is what it is. I mean,
he really belongs just on the sports show.
No, no, no. I'm
sports
just
is gay.
I think it was like me and Emily's third
date.
Where
else can you slap man in the ass?
I was asking her about and I asked her, I was like, what about Skull and Bone Society? Because, like, you know, they made the movie, and, like, of course I asked. She's like, oh, yeah, I've been to their parties. They fucking suck. They're all a bunch
why
of ladies.
Why is it okay?
It's like, hello, Skull and Bones
why
party,
is it,
guys.
Why is it gay to do certain things, but it's not gay to slap a guy in the ass? To say good game.
No, they do that now.
No penetration. That's the rule.
It depends. And slapping a guy on the ass depends on the circumstances.
Right.
Okay?
But to be
if
fair.
If you're on a sports field and you slap a guy on the ass, fine. But
that's
if you're
one thing,
walking
right.
down a hall
can you
and you slap a guy
bite?
On the ass, uh-uh.
But to be fair, right. at Bob's age, all asses have depends.
Wow.
You have to sample that
sound. Is slapping a guy on the ass acceptable?
Depends.
He depends
Bob's, on the circumstance.
Bob just hit it right on the nose. He
depends
really did.
Depends on the circumstance.
What's the circumstance?
Now, if
you're on an athletic field.
What if he bought like a nice
how
package?
How close you are to balls.
What if you got a really good price on cheese at the supermarket and you wanted to
not
make,
acceptable.
Nah. Good game.
Wait, how cheap was that cheese?
Why don't
$3.99 a pound.
On the golf course, not acceptable.
I'll tell you what. If you're at a bowling alley and the guy gets a strike and he walks back, you don't slap him on the ass.
No, you high five.
You give him a high five.
High five.
Otherwise, you're gay.
Exactly.
Why is that
exactly.
not acceptable?
It's like,
oh, so running after them in leotards, basically, at 100 miles an hour?
Which they, do they only
which
do
is
that
called
in
football.
They don't do that in basketball.
Yeah, but they don't do it.
Yeah, they do.
Yeah, they do.
Yeah, they do.
The
yeah.
most manliest sport, they hit each other on the ass.
They don't
they do
it in wrestling.
Why don't women
yeah, they do.
Yeah, they do.
Oh, they do?
Yeah.
Okay, then.
No, they just teabag
well,
each
then,
other.
That doesn't help my
then I should sign up for wrestling. I'm just going
no, you got too many blood clots. You can't do that.
Yeah, no, yeah.
They might kick
die.
The scab out of your chest.
Yeah. You might get a staph infection doing
not
that.
Not everyone has scabs all over their body, Peter. I don't have staph infection yet.
Just inside.
In his soul. Well, you guys, I'm going to get up to put my guitar away. Don't slap me in the ass.
I won't.
We can't
I
give you
a no promise. No promises.
Yeah, I can't.
So slapping you in the ass would be...
Guilty!
Okay, you can.
Now
Bob,
gonna...
give him a good game.
Give him a good game. Bobby just hit a hole in one.
Give
go
him a fatherly
it.
Slap.
No,
on
you
the
get
ass.
A hole in one. That's called a bar tab.
I'd like to see ass slapping in golf.
You know what? Quiet sport in the world.
In the Ryder Cup, that would be the only time. But you know what? They won't do that in golf.
That's a
they
high
won't.
Five.
It makes too
exactly.
They won't. It makes too much noise.
Who would do it? The caddy would have to do it.
Hey, it's okay for Tiger Woods to fart on the golf course, and they have it broadcasted.
Wait, really?
I missed that.
Yes. Well, go look it up on YouTube.
I don't know what was better, his game or his fart. He's not. I mean, he used
go,
to be
no,
good.
No, no, no. Put it up on YouTube. If you put it up on YouTube, go right ahead.
Put what up on YouTube?
Tiger Woods farting,
farts,
apparently.
Right on live TV.
We already seen
that. Can you hear it?
Yeah.
We already seen that.
It's a good-ass mic.
We already seen that.
Oh, you already did it?
Yeah, and the comment from Mike Tirico was, you won't get that over in England next week.
Oh, Jesus.
So,
why is a fart an abomination?
You're the one who called it an abomination. You took it to
a
whole new level.
But they made a whole YouTube
video
about it.
It's because Hillary farted and she lost.
Because it was funny.
Why is it when a...
It's not an abomination. It's funny.
Why is it when a biracial person farts, it becomes an abomination all of a sudden?
You mean like OBAMA nation?
Look, if Derek Jeter farted, okay, when people were saying shit like that...
You only get half as mad, though.
I know, Derek Jeter.
Wow, how are we getting a Jeter?
Oh, God.
Because the fuck
he's a biracial angel.
Because they're retiring his number.
I know.
I'm so stoked on
that. I like
that,
how
dude.
They drag those things out.
I think now with what him things? Retiring, it's all the single digits are retired for the Yankees now.
Yeah.
We'll talk about that on sports, though. Let's get into something
else. Yeah, let's talk about
anything
else.
We finally started talking about a sport that I wanted to talk about.
I know, because you got the hat on.
Born and raised, dude.
Hey,
Bronx.
At least you got two good teams, but we'll leave it at that.
Yeah. That is the
squirting
book.
Oh, that's the ejaculation book.
Wait.
You want to read it?
Squirting book.
Because
just pick a random passage.
You want to read a chapter? Yeah.
Because you have to leave early, you have to read one verse.
But you have to do it in your most racist accent you could think of. Like any ethnicity, nothing's off limits.
You want to read a chapter, Eugene, or no?
I can't because the last time I was on, I read... like most of the book, and when I got home, there were expectations that I set. if I can't go near that,
so
it's very hard
listening?
To do.
We'll have Bob take notes for you.
So you're at Cafe 9. What when?
December 12th.
December 12th. Yeah.
Who are you playing 12th. With on the 12th?
TL Band, Plum Rose, and Spencer O'Day's band, Pan Galactic.
Oh, yeah.
Am I saying that right?
Yeah, I think
I
so.
Think so.
It's, I mean, we'll both
you got
wrong,
anything
so
else besides that, before the end of the year?
Yeah, actually, in Stratford, where my town, Stratford, I'm so proud of my town with 63,000 people.
Oh, yeah, it's great.
Main Street Tavern on the 23rd, which I haven't been there since it was called Mr. P's.
Holy
like
shit.
Long, that's a long time ago. That's a strip joint. Yeah.
No,
Mr. P's.
No, no, no.
It was just like a dangerous
where
bar.
Where was this?
Yeah.
Main it was Street a biker Tavern. Bar.
Holy yeah. crap. Yeah. I forgot that it was Mr. P's.
Mr. P's was a dance club, and it was Main Street Tavern.
But Mr. P's was...
Mr. P's didn't have strippers.
No, but they had dance club. They had DJ dancing.
But I think Mike worked there.
That was later.
It did have a lot of bikers.
It was later.
They have bikers now.
It was a biker bar back then, and it was rough.
Yeah, but it was wasn't it called something else? It wasn't called Mr. P's, was it?
Some guy actually got like murdered there. Yes. His father flipped out, and he went there with a shotgun and burnt the place to the ground. So the story goes.
Yeah.
It's like a.
I can
local
see that
legend.
Happening.
Like, it's weird to see because I remember when, in high school, I was like, I'm
now
never going
like
to go
a,
there. That's where you go to get stabbed. But now, it's just a bunch of guys, just a bunch of hipster kids hanging around Main Street Tavern. Because it's the only bar in Stratford that isn't terrifying.
but it's not hipsters anymore.
I mean,
it's mostly, actually, it's bikers. Most of the people in there are now bikers.
Nice
nowadays
in Stratford. Yeah.
He means I mean, we play there.
It's not rough.
Yeah.
It's not rough. They keep it
you
straight.
About Main Street traffic. I was like, what's the deal with the place? What's it like?
When we go, it's like me, the guys from Grolix, pass down the dirty boots. It's like mostly musicians and millennial kids from the
all
scene.
All those likes, no one listens.
Somebody was messaging you too.
It's I don't know. It's basically a local bar now.
Yeah. Okay.
And they've got a steady crew of regulars.
Well, Ricky,
Ricky and I are going to a place on Friday?
I don't know.
Friday.
Try Friday.
You go there. It's in New York City. Anybody wants to go, you can. Yeah, you can pay for your own ride.
Metro
We're going North. There. You get off the train. You get onto the bar. And you walk up to the bar. And they give you a robe.
Oh,
and you put this robe on.
I don't like where this is going.
And you go upstairs, and they
just
have
like an
igloos.
Eyes Wide Shut situation.
It's on the 250th floor or something like that. They have igloos, and you sit and you drink hot apple cider.
Oh, that was the thing you put on Facebook.
Yeah, you drink hot apple cider.
What's the name of it?
The 250th Club or something.
I gotta check.
Right
off
of Grand Central, right?
I don't know where it is. I gotta look it up. Cool. And it's actually affordable prices. It was $8 or $9 for a cider. And you sit on the roof in an igloo. It's all heated igloo, and you sit on the roof and
Dude,
New York
probably,
City.
That the view's gonna be
250 floors high.
I'll put up my Christmas tree.
That's high.
That sounds pretty cool.
Yeah, we're gonna go. Fuck it. We wanted something to do. Is there anybody know of a place in this state that has dueling piano bars?
Yes.
And you know what? I've heard of
not
dueling
in this state.
Pianos.
Not in this state. I was thinking of something New Orleans.
Oh.
Yeah.
Yeah, if you want
a
weekend drive.
I know, we'll just drive there now.
Way to go.
Not dueling piano bars, but from my friend Larry Erickson, who owns Jesse Camille's and JC 1757. He would have a dueling piano act that would play once in a while. Which is actually really good. Stop yawning over there. You're giving
Are we boring
air.
You?
Didn't I just ask that?
Yeah.
Bob?
Yeah, okay. I think so.
Okay. Dead air.
No dead air.
No, not you, him.
I felt.
What did I do?
Are you ready to leave?
Yeah.
All right, Eugene, just stay.
Hey, be good.
Wait,
nice job. Nice
Let
job.
Me know about you, Con.
I'm down, man. All
right, give me a date.
Okay, cool.
I will.
All right. We'll see.
It's Thursdays.
I'll probably see you Monday.
All right.
Thursdays, okay, 8 to 10.
Be good.
Bye. Nice to meet you. Try safe. Eugene Gallagher.
I mean, I could find out when my friend's holding that show again, but I mean, like I said.
Are you sure there are going to be two pianos there?
That's how dueling pianos works, Peter. There's fucking two of them.
I know. You didn't hear them.
Well,
you didn't hear him.
Well, it's funny.
I said, is there a bar that has dueling pianos? He goes, no, but I think my friend has a place with two pianos.
No. It's they don't hold it all the time.
No, I know. But
they're not dueling. They're just together.
No. But I mean,
they're single pianos.
No, I mean, he doesn't. Like I said, he doesn't hold it all the time. I mean,
yeah,
the guy
it's
owns
just an
a
act. It's just an act that comes in once in a while.
Actually, what is that bar that closed down in New Haven that used to do it all the time? What?
Keys to the City, Key to the City,
oh,
or something.
I wasn't here yet.
So Orlando has a great nightlife because they have a place that's doing pianos all night.
Yes.
7 days a week. Their karaoke isn't regular karaoke like a DJ. They have a full band.
Yep.
That you stand in front of. They have backup singers.
Yeah.
They have a Jimmy Buffett place to
Jimmy
hang
Buffett?
Out.
Jimmy Buffett, yes.
And they also have, who's the guy, the Rasta guy?
They used to have the Baja Beach
Bob
Club.
Bob
Marley?
He's dead.
Yeah, but they have a bar named after him.
Oh, yeah.
They brought him back to life.
Dude, their bars are back 7 days a week.
That's a promotion I'm going to check out.
The prices are dead.
Orlando Kissimmee area got so much going on down there. So much. And it's nowhere near like it used to be back in the 1990s.
Mm. When all the straight people were there?
Very true. And you walk into the Baja Beach Club, you pay $5 cover charge, you got a DJ. Girl in a bikini walks up, hey, you want a shot? Yeah, I think a shot for $5. All right, get on your knees.
You're wrong, okay?
No, I'm not, because it happened to me.
Todd Daly.
Puts it right in between the chest.
Yeah.
Right.
Giggity, giggity.
No, that was a lot.
Just a little one.
The gays got to you with their insidious ways.
Oh no, she didn't.
Oh yeah, she did.
Oh she was from Ohio.
Ohio.
Did you want to do a song?
Yes. Yes, I would. I
know
very
you're itching over there to do a song.
Yeah, be great. Great.
He brought his. He brought his ukulele.
Yeah, I got to figure out how to do the ukulele. I need like a mic for that because it's not. I don't plug in.
You got like three of them in front of you, dude.
Yeah, I know. Funny how that works.
Tired tonight?
A little bit.
People are tired. I mean, that...
It's this way I'm sitting.
It's driving. It's the tree.
I know. I got to sit like a fat guy with my legs spread.
Jesus Christ.
It's the staph infection. I hope it's not contagious. All the shit I've been talking.
All right.
I can fling it at you like a monkey with poo.
Please don't.
Got to turn the other mic on?
Yeah.
He's back.
Oh, God.
Oh, that's awkward.
No, it's my turn now.
What'd you lose?
No, that's ours.
Keys?
That's awkward. He loves his food now. Hmm? No cool, eh?
You didn't put it in your coat?
Right, this is why we gotta wait like 5 minutes before we start talking shit.
And by that time, it's the break.
He knows I was kidding.
That's why he came back.
So I did a show at Cafe 9 last week on Tuesday, and I did some new stuff, so I figured I'd do one of the songs from that set. I wrote a song about my dog, because I was like sick of writing really serious stuff. So here we go. Let me tell you all about my baby, da-da-da-da. She's got the biggest smile, she never let me down. Well, she's one hell of a lady. Da, 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 da. Got the biggest smile, she never let me down. Well, don't need no fancy cars, don't need no diamond rings, don't need no concert hall. This is the kind of girl you only see in dreams, the kind who's only there to help you when you fall. Let me tell you all about my baby, da, 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 da. She is the one for me, she never let me down. Oh, she's one hell of a perfect lady, da, 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 da. Oh, how I love my baby doll.
Whoa.
Don't need no fancy car, don't need no diamond rings, don't need no concert hall. This is the kind of girl you only see in dreams of time, who's always there to catch you when you fall. Let me tell you all about my baby, da 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 da. This is the one for me, she never lets me down. Oh, she's one hell of a perfect lady. Oh, how I love my baby doll. You when you fall, let me tell you
da 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 da. She is the one for me, she never lets me down. Oh, oh, she's one hell of a perfect lady. Oh, how I love my baby doll.
I'm still working out the bugs
yeah.
on it. It's like...
Oh,
like,
yeah.
So for folks at home who can't see, I have a baritone ukulele, and I just started like learning how to actually play
it. They can't see you. That's the problem.
Oh, can they see
you? Yeah,
yeah.
You're on
show
camera.
It. Oh, so yeah. I got this baritone ukulele that
you
I'm still learning how to play.
You have frostbite yet?
And, yeah.
I'm a little,
it's been
I'm a little bit
cold. Little chilly.
We told you about that.
Yeah,
spot.
I felt that breeze
I'm
coming.
A
you all right?
Nippy.
But that's why you got the tree protecting you.
No, you don't.
It ain't helping you.
It's a fake tree.
I know that.
Spoiler alert.
Hello. So what do how do we approach? It's gonna be hard. How do we approach Thursday after doing this so long?
I don't know.
Yeah.
I don't know either.
Is parking?
Like, we're gonna we, have to.
Oh yeah.
We're gonna have to pray a lot.
Oh no!
No swearing.
Like, how do you start off a conversation? And well, it's I've done it before with AJ or KJ.
Yeah.
At APJ, it's not that hard.
You just gotta roll.
We've been doing this for so long. It's like, what are we talking about?
I was gonna say, it seems like more like it's just like you're
no,
you
but you know
that.
What? I mean, you're going into a public, a public thing now instead of an internet thing, so there's no swearing.
No, well, no, this stuff. Will be
internet,
internet but
too.
They run it by the same rules as if you were on an FCC
exactly.
station.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Right. Exactly.
Like, we've never done an all the times we've been with you, we've never done like a in depth interview with you.
Yeah.
So I think it's gonna be really interesting.
Could be.
Ooh, I'll be more worried about cool. you and my wife driving home later alone.
I don't think there's any problem.
If there was, I wouldn't allow it. Don't
yeah,
worry about
I understand.
Yeah. I've been teasing Ricky.
But we won't like, tell anyway.
She's like,
there you go.
She's Peter, like, we won't tell anyway. So.
I don't know
what happens
it'll be Ricky. It'll be our secret.
What happens on 66 days?
That was so creepy.
It
was,
be our right?
secret.
I'll never tell.
Remember that when I'm holding the paddles over your chest. What happened that night, Bob?
What happened that night?
What happened? Claire. Oop. Yep. Zero. Yeah.
Uber.
The funny thing about Bob's heart attack, it happened at the end of the staircase. It's weird.
It did.
So clumsy, Bob.
Yeah.
So when you get there, it's really hard to tell people. When you get there, you have to Google the student center.
Okay.
Yep.
Which the student center is diagonal, because if you stay across, it goes to the legal building.
Google the student in the center. Okay.
It's diagonal from Gamble, the rear. I don't know what
oh,
the
wow,
rear
okay.
or what the front entrance is. But the student center
Ricky,
is the place.
You know how to get
yeah,
there?
Yeah, she knows how to get there.
Okay, so no. I'm not worried.
He's like, I'm just going to follow you.
GPS.
Leave early.
It's across from the jail.
GPS.
Student center is
Oates Hall.
Diagonal from Gamble. That's all you need to remember.
Oh, there you go.
Oh, okay.
It's the center of campus.
Okay.
They're building a brand new sports complex across the street from it.
Yep.
It's across from the lacrosse field.
Is there like a name of a hall
field?
Or anything?
Like,
yeah. Oak Hall is next to it.
Oak Hall, okay.
But if you Google the student center, or just Google WHUS, it brings you Hillside
okay.
Road or something.
Whatever.
I'll figure it out.
Hey, man.
I'm not driving, so I'm not worried.
No, but you're my wife's driving. I'll already be up there amassing shit.
And I'm going to wear my diaper.
Wow.
He didn't have to tell anybody, but he did, and that's why he's such a great guy.
And he says he can't remember shit.
I can't remember.
He can
remember
only
that.
remember
shit. If Ricky gets on top of that, he'll remember it.
Oh.
Now,
and I'll remember it at his eulogy.
Right. Now, what's the format? Is it a two-hour talk show? Are you doing just well, talk?
I just said
mix?
That. I don't know.
Wait, you don't have a
format?
How much
did
time are we doing?
What
the fuck are you doing?
Don't have a how many breaks are there? How much time? Do you know? Nothing.
We're kind of winging it.
there's 2 hours, so...
We one break.
Yeah.
I like how you say it so...
There's
somebody
going to do. Somebody so, going to do the news at the top of the hour or something? No.
No, Ricky's going to start... We're going to incorporate Ricky into doing stories.
Ah.
Because we're going to feed off of Ricky.
I'm a little concerned about that.
Why?
Stories about what?
She's got to come up with stories. I asked her, before you guys even came along, we had a gay psychic who would do cock topics.
What?
So,
wow.
Like Wendy Williams does Hot Topics. We call them cock topics. Yeah. Oh. So he would go into magazines or TMZ and find stories. So we figured if Ricky finds stories, four or five of them, we could feed off of those stories.
Yeah, that's fine.
Because
yeah,
you can't do news on that radio station unless it comes from a credible news source.
Right. Like, you can't just make up stuff.
Yeah. No. Oh, but they don't have – it's not regular programming,
it's
they don't
commercial.
Have –
it's non-commercial.
Right.
That's
okay. So you can't, like, do – if TMZ, I don't know if how credible that is, but, like, if it's gossip –
it's really hard about what you can do. Like, you can't say the end of the world is coming, but you can say one day the world will end.
You know what might be a good topic for Thursday night?
No.
No, 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 seriously.
Boner alert.
Tomorrow night, the UConn women are number one in the country. They're playing Notre Dame as the number two team in the country. So that might be a topic.
No, time out.
Are they playing
it's the
home?
Other way around? UConn is number two.
No.
Notre Dame is one.
No, go look at the ratings. It's not reversed.
Are they playing at home?
They're playing in Notre Dame, but still, it might be a top. It might be a good topic.
Well, Eugene is watching. We can't talk about him anymore.
No, I know the game will be over, but it might be an idea to recap it about how
the dynasty
left and won four in a row.
Well, it's not a sports show.
I understand, but
okay, just because it's UConn, it's not a sports show.
No, I know, but I'm just thinking UConn draw interest.
We could talk about the overwhelming amount of yoga pants that walked through that campus today.
Oh my god!
There you go.
I'm going to have to relieve myself before.
Well, we
can
talk about yoga pants.
Yeah, I understand that, but there's a reaction.
I might just
for you.
I think I'm going to shave and pretend I'm a student.
Ricky and I talk like best friends. We're
you
okay
understand
with that.
Though. You're talking. Your audience is college kids.
They're going to love yoga pants.
They're going to want to know.
You're going to have feminists busting down your door, dude, like freaking out because you're talking about yoga pants.
No.
Feminist till graduation.
They had a big thing in Rhode Island about that. One of the news anchors was saying how women should not be wearing yoga pants as a public outfit.
How can you teach?
Because that's not news, though.
So 300 women went in front of his house and fucking protested.
Yeah, and that's what you want to happen to you.
In yoga pants.
That'd be great. Hey, I want to do that.
Yeah, halfway through the sentence, I was like, yeah, he probably does want a bunch of yoga pants hanging outside of the studio.
The last thing I want is naked women in front of my apartment.
You know, the last people that are listening to a college station are college kids.
That's true.
Very true.
It's the kids that don't go out. They're just like, oh, fuck this, man.
The only crowd they get are the people from Hartford, people from Rhode Island that are driving in their cars. They don't get, like, college. College kids don't want to hear their own, you know, their own station. Like,
it depends.
They listen to Pandora, dude.
Especially on Thursday night. Thursday night's party night.
Oh, we should get them to call in. Just have mass.
Yeah, we can spring break when we're broadcasting from there. Spring break.
Oh, you know what we should do? We should do a character where you can ask a character anything.
I'll send somebody out with a microphone.
A guy questions. On the street?
Yeah.
That'd be cool.
Question.
That'd be cool as hell.
So somebody to gamble. We're like, hey,
exactly.
What do you think of huskies?
Just send us and go run around and just fucking ask random shit.
Yeah, Dennis, what do you think about scabs in the lung? Is that
it's like, have you been walking today? If you don't,
you're actually in a good place if something happens.
Ask questions, I'll just eagerly hold the microphone in front of them and be like, uh-huh.
Yeah. I don't even, you know, we just write like a list of like bullshit questions. Are you there? Okay, good. Moving on.
Like, what do you think about Obama coming out as a lizard person? Just like, see how they react.
Is Obama really black?
What do you think about the critics who believe the moon doesn't exist?
They're just going to blank out.
Okay,
has anybody ever figured out what are those,
that's
the
chemistry
those
group.
Dents and holes are in the moon?
They're craters, dude. They have them from meteorites hitting the moon.
Meteorites?
Yeah. They're dick holes
from a long time ago.
Why do they hit the moon and not us?
I mean,
they burn up in our atmosphere, but
a lot of them hit the moon and they cause those craters.
But at the same time, there are craters that do get caused in on Earth, but they're just not nearly as... We have the atmosphere, it slows it down, and then there's...
It makes them smaller and
cushion. And a lot of them hit the ocean. I mean, odds are you're going to hit the ocean. It's most of the surface area of the...
Yeah, there is a lot more ocean than land, right?
Yeah.
I saw a deep science impact. Section. Oh. Huh? Do like a science section on the show. Like, so you just find it like National Geographic's kids.
they should have me ask questions, like kids that are in class. Like,
apparently there are eight
you
planets.
You should see some of the shows that they do. Like, there's an hour show that's called Study Time.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah. Probably.
And they'll sit on the air for an hour and study.
Wow. What the fuck? What do you mean they study for an hour?
It's study time.
Were they calling and they ask questions?
It's
about
the study time hour.
Yeah. Oh, dude, we should pretend to be students and just have a call. Hi, I'm 19 I don't know how to do laundry. can anyone help me? Can anyone? I'm looking for a woman, preferably because my mom does it and she's really good. I need someone to teach me how to do laundry. I would appreciate that. I'm in room 404.
Okay.
Silly jerky boy stuff. Yeah. Just like messing for
just like makeup characters.
Rock soup obviously is rock. Study break.
What the fuck?
From 6:30 to 7:30.
Yeah, they got a Spanish. What else they got? They got bluegrass.
Spotlight smash. Bosco James. It's.
Can't wait to 2 hours of me burping.
We should just go to the student website and just pick random names.
2 hours of my gnarly ass beer burping.
Are you on the schedule yet, Peter?
No.
No.
Even they just put me on the employee page. That's our studio right there.
Oh wow.
We should just friend people at UConn and just make
up
stories.
But even when you go to the regular one, like the regular schedule, that's even like look at this. Here, see this guy automation?
Ooh. Yeah.
That means there's nobody there.
Really?
It's automated. It's an automated
system. Okay.
Oh.
We hope to make it to here.
So do you have like an eventual like idea for a format, or are you just winging it as you go?
No, we're going to do a talk show up there. But it's mostly going to be Spotlight. It's going to be called the Peter Pinho Show, obviously.
Yeah.
But it's going to be a Spotlight. Like, we never really get to sit down with just
one person.
And like, actually interview them.
And have like 30 people not interject.
Yeah.
That's what it's going to be.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah.
That's a good idea.
So, okay. So I'm just...
No.
Okay.
Over here, we all could. We have.
Yeah, it's like.
Over here, it's a free for all. Over there, you're structured. You have to.
Oh, no, I know. So we're interviewing Bob. Is that what I'm.
Bob, we've never interviewed Bob.
That could take up like 6 hours.
Bob, start from the beginning. I was born.
Ask him about the Civil War.
But you know.
What happened in the Declaration of Independence?
What, Ben?
I was thinking that Dennis can interview Bob in different characters.
Yeah,
that's not a bad idea.
That'd be pretty funny.
It's because you're hot doesn't like, mean you're
hi, Bob. I'm part of the student council that no one knows about. I'd like to know what's it like to be that old?
And he goes into a brother accent after that.
Yo, man, you watch the basketball games?
She takes over the playlist one day and she's, oh my God.
Oh my God. I never
oh my
talk.
God, the music was so good today.
I kind of like the idea. I really do.
You should have seen it. She was like so proud.
I was.
Bob got
so
a big old dick.
She did do a good job.
Yeah.
Bob swings, dick swings too big, man.
I still
no, you can't swear.
Do.
You can't say that.
No,
you can't say.
Dick's not a swear.
Is dick a swear?
No.
What if
no,
he says penis?
I said Bob's dick too big.
You can't say Bob's dick is thrusting inside of her. You can
yeah, but I can
Bob's
say it's so big, it takes yeah. it takes three legs to hold it up.
You can't be descriptive. How's that? Like, Ricky, you can't complain about our sex drive.
Our sex drive. No.
That's my rule. That's
like,
my rule.
Like it's a group problem. Like it's
Bob, how about
that's
this?
My rule. Don't talk about it.
How about we do a beginning where I'm like, Bob's one of the brave Americans.
You're not even showing up till 9.
CRS. Today, we're interviewing Bob, noted author of the book, CRS, and how it affects your life.
You guys wait till you go there because it's like when I went there, it was like, all right, you got to walk in, you got to sign in, you got to be structured, you got to make sure. Like, you guys walk in here, it's like, hey, what's going on?
No, it ain't like that up there.
Over there, no.
Hello. Oh. We're here today talking about Bob.
Yeah. Well, they got to make sure they know who's in the building.
Right.
Yeah, you got to sign in. Yeah. You got to sign in. Everybody has to
hand
sign
out.
In. Hand out. But there's a good thing, though, is if you get there early, there is places to eat. Like, there's a Sbarro.
Yep.
Yeah.
There's a Panda Express.
There's
right?
a bunch of stuff in that area.
There's a whole kitchen downstairs.
Are you doing it next week, too?
Every week.
Okay. I wouldn't mind doing it next week, too.
And then we're going to be doing it through the break, too, so we'll be the all only right. ones there.
Oh, wow.
Sick.
Dennis heard you say Panda Express. He's like, I want to be there next week, too.
You look really excited about the Panda Express.
Here's the thing about the Panda Express, though. The Panda Express is the worst ride at Six Flags. Because it's right next to the Pandorum Express or something like that. And every time I go next to it, I'm like, I'm retarded. We'll be right back.
And I walk for my machine. All I really want is something. All I really want is something beautiful to say.
To PPRN, motherfucker.
Can you feel it crush you? Does it seem to bring the worst in you out? There's no running away from these things that hold you down. Do they complicate you? 'Cause they make you feel like this of all the colors.
Yo.
Hey, what's up, my people? How you doing? How you fucking doing? It's Chris. What's up? Bueno.
Stupid bitch. No, you can't show up on time?
I'm so sorry. Mad shit happens. Like, it was crazy. I'm so sorry I wasn't live.
Why do you sound like Girls Gone Wild?
Mad shit happened. That is fucking crazy.
Because I got my tits out this time. I was so excited. I'm just like, I have a boner right now. I don't know how I can hide it. Hold on.
Yo.
Where are you right now?
Where's Tuck Jeb?
I'm right now. Like, I'm going down through, just getting to Bridgeport right now.
From where?
Like, it's just crazy. It's raining mad. What did my day been crazy. Huh?
Did your house blow away or something?
They evicted him from his
actually,
dumpster.
It's like a really long story. I can say that shit live. It's a mad story that guy.
You sound drunk.
You sound like you're crazy.
Both, actually.
No, I'm already crazy. That's what happened.
Did you say it's raining men?
Hallelujah.
What happened?
Hallelujah.
Did you say it's raining? You say it's raining
don't
men?
Don't you know it's bueno?
It's raining men? Yes, it's raining men from the sky, and they're blue.
Wow.
Motherfucker, what are you on right now? And yeah, can I have some?
Yeah, what are you doing?
He's on ecstasy.
He's on some shit.
No, I'm not. I'm in mad coffee right now. I need to stay awake. That shit's crazy.
What, you drink?
It's a mad. It's really crazy.
It ain't coffee, I promise you that.
He's on the coquito.
Yeah, some alcohol. So I need some alcohol right now, but I can't have alcohol. I'm not. I haven't get home yet since this morning. I woke up at 4 in the morning. I went to my job, but then my shit happened, and I haven't seen my penis in all day. I haven't taken shit all day. Like, I need to do that right now.
Chris Bueno, what's it like out there?
It's raining men from the skies, and they're blue.
Why are they
blue? Sure, it's not from the Blue Oyster Club.
There's a fucking dolphin right now, right next to me. Like, there's a dolphin walking around.
Wait. A dolphin?
It's raining.
Dolphin?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, dolphin. It's on Bridgeport. There's a dolphin. There's so many water in here that you can see dolphins swimming and walking on the street. But this is just incredibly fucked up. I don't even know how to explain this shit.
You're missing. Everybody's dancing in here right now.
Oh, I just feel the power.
We need to hear about the ejaculation.
Ejaculation,
baby.
It's raining bilingual men. Portuguese, Spanish, and black for me.
I have never seen this video. It is awesome.
Oh, no, you need to put Macho Man there. What happened? You need to Macho Man, man.
No, we ain't playing
Macho Man, man.
You keep it up. We're going to go to the Blue Oyster Club from Police Academy.
I think Chris should just call in from now on. I don't think he should ever actually show up.
I'm really sorry I missed the day because, guys, I'm really sorry. It's my life. My life is really fucked up sometimes, but I'm really sorry. But now, anyway, did I get it on time for the whatever did you guys learn today? Or am I too late? Too early?
You're way too early for what you learned. We know you're a macho man.
What happened?
We can see you right now in your room, like 80 pounds, with your white underwear all the way up to your nipples, soaked wet. And putting cologne on your balls right now, dancing to this.
With the wig on.
Screaming out to your landlord, hey, you didn't pay the rent this week.
You know, my favorite way of dancing that kind of song is just putting tape in my balls and no hairs on it.
Hey, who's your landlord? U-Haul?
He's like, I couldn't pay U-Haul. The rent. I had to pay the dolphin. I owe me like $10, man.
Is U-Haul your landlord or do you get your apartments at the Walmart?
He's got it in a budget.
I wish I could get it on Walmart, man.
He finds the right refrigerator store.
You know, if you use duct tape and not clear tape, it holds the box inside her.
Oh, my God.
Ready?
Macho man. Woo! A macho man. Macho man.
Macho man.
I want you to pay my rent for the month of June.
I think this is the first time a song played after said the box.
Every time he goes to me, he always asks me like, hey man, you know what time it is? I go slow like, oh yeah, it's peanut butter and jelly time. Fuck it, I never pay rent.
I thought it was
the
election time.
I watch and I go, like, oh yeah, it's peanut butter and jelly time. I just start walking fast, so he don't notice. Peanut butter jelly time. That's exactly how I go.
Oh, my God.
That's not what she said.
You know, it's funny. You see all these people that have issues with homes and hard to find it hard to live, but they always have good spirits, their phone bill paid.
And they got peanut butter jelly time.
And a ride anywhere they need to go.
Well, because you know what, Peter? Because we leave every single day like it's the last one. We always have. I need to have fun. If I die tomorrow, I know you guys know how I live happily, even in my life and shit. That's the way we do it. That's what we report, and we live laughing my whole life. And I will do it at the end of my days, man. And I love being crazy like this. It's
what are they calling live from Brazil?
Dude, he's so fucked up right now.
And if he died tomorrow, Storytime Bob would win the death pool.
So cut it out.
So don't die
what
yet.
What happened, Bob? I haven't heard Bob. Bob is there, though?
Oh, yeah, I'm here.
Bob died.
Oh, I haven't heard you, Bob. Hi, Bob. How are you doing, man?
I'm doing good.
Haven't heard you.
I haven't heard you.
I had bad shit happen today. I couldn't hear you.
I didn't know you were a hairdresser and Jewish. I haven't heard you.
How was that blowjob? It was good?
Wow.
Wow. From Lacey? Oh,
was that the one on the merit?
Did you get one from Lacey?
I hate when you come on my mouth. I hate that, Joe. I don't do that again.
Yeah. We were talking about that earlier.
He must have been listening. You were listening.
Yeah, you were listening, huh?
No wonder why he was going 35 and a 65.
Chris, did you talk?
He was going 69.
He was a good jerk off, but just to call me on my mouth, I don't know. I'm going to think about that. I need a second chance.
A second chance?
I love a confused, broken accent. I don't know if I want it to come in my mouth, but I'm going to take a second chance.
Bob's Parkinson's kicked in, and he sprained his dick.
Looking for a ride on the busted rocket.
It was so good, he gave him a stutter.
Did you get a mouthful of
powder? Is Mikey there, though? He's not
no,
there?
Mike's
no,
there.
Mike's not here. Mike's not here.
Did you get a mouthful of powder when he blew his load?
What happened?
Did you get a mouthful of powder when he blew his load?
It makes
not
it
even,
safe.
No, it actually smelled like pee. My mouth was smelling like pee. I don't think he was calm. I think he peed on me. I'm pretty sure that's what happened.
Lemonade.
He's like, look, my balls don't work. I'm just going to piss.
Oh, my God.
This hour brought to you by Country Time Lemonade.
just think of me as a squirter.
Christ.
I'm Bob the Sprinkler Man.
Bob, don't worry, Bob. It wasn't good ejaculation. Don't worry.
That's Bob's porn name, Irrigation Bob.
when he got hard, I scared myself. I thought he was going to die or some shit.
Oh, so you're trying to win a death pool, you filthy bitch.
I would fuck him into the afterlife. That's the sound his dick makes when he comes.
it's like making tea with a dick.
Tea's ready.
Oh, my God. It's not raining right
damn
now.
Damn it. So
like
much
I'm
for
walking
Adrian.
Right now.
Where are you walking from? You have a car.
Where are you walking?
No, to my apartment. I haven't get in. Hey. I'm walking right now in the street because there's no parking. I'm super wet right now.
Is your apartment like soaking now? Do you have to replace like the roof, the walls, and everything else?
Dude, I think I left my window open. I don't even know.
Oh, it sucks.
When
you
say window, is that the top of the box?
Yes. I leave in a carton box. That's actually going to be wet from top to the bottom.
You can use Savers bags to keep it waterproof.
you know what really happened yesterday? I went to the bathroom and there was shit all over. Like somebody shit even on the top of the bathroom. It was crazy.
How many people share a bathroom?
What do you got, 12 people?
12.
12?
12 people.
No, he told us
people
last time.
And 4 kids.
One shower in 17 Guatemalans?
Yes.
Wow. Don't you be racist.
He must be in Costa Carolina.
No, don't worry. It's 16 Guatemalans and one Honduran.
You have 17 people sharing one shower?
Yes, one shower, one toilet, one kitchen, everything.
Do you have a schedule for the shower?
No, you know, like every time I gotta take a shower at 4 a.m. in the morning, that's the time I gotta set up for myself.
Are you in prison?
Is somebody know an apartment?
No,
or
here's
a studio. Let me
I got
know.
A solution,
be great.
Here's what you do.
Yeah, leave Bridgeport.
Yeah,
you get
step
a,
one.
You get
move to Naugatuck.
Yeah,
you get.
I want to go. I want to go white people. I want to go white people places. That's good.
No, here's what you get a gym membership. Get a gym membership at like,
I don't know. Go to the
Y. Move to the YMCA.
$10. $10 a month. You
Chris,
get a
go to the YMCA.
You can hang out with all the boys.
At least you get a free membership.
YMCA.
They have apartments at the YMCA.
Yeah.
Yeah, the only problem is Bob's
people?
Oh,
no. No, the YMCA. It's a real place.
No, he's right. It's about $105 a week and gets a free gym membership. Why not?
He's like, no, that place is made up. I heard this song.
Why don't you
stop kidding?
Stop kidding.
I would love to be at the YMCA. Stop kidding. Stop kidding.
Oh,
why are you teasing me?
No, but for real. Really, if you find an apartment that somebody's going to take,
I just fucking told you. The YMCA. I just told you.
YMCA. How do you apply for that? I don't even
you
I don't
go.
Know.
Go
you
to
go
the
there.
Go to the Y and say, I need a
and
room.
Apply for it.
All right, I will.
Say, my name is Chris. I need a room to stay. I might be gay.
It'll cost him just as much to get a studio.
And when they ask me sex, yes.
What you should do is go to an extended stay.
Yeah, they're pretty cheap.
You can get an extended stay for about $175 a week.
Yep.
Nice. That sounds good, though.
That's a lot of money. That's almost a rent.
Yeah.
It's more than the rent.
But they clean the room.
I can tell you.
But
right
you get everything, though. Electricity, cable, room. If he's by himself, it's worth it.
Yeah.
It is.
And they provide you with a bed and all that shit.
Yeah, they give you your whole room, dude. It's like a studio.
And they clean it, right?
They clean it once a day.
It's like a hotel.
Mm-hmm.
It is a hotel.
Actually, no, they don't clean it until you pay your rent.
Welcome to
then they come in and clean it, and then you're all set.
I stayed at one for like a month.
Yeah, I stayed at one in Florida.
Oh, wow. I had to eat out, though. It sucked. Eating out for everyone sucks.
I was waiting for the hit.
Yeah, a lot of those places don't have a cooking place.
Yeah, like
the hotel I stay at in Rhode Island has cooking.
Like, eating out's fun, but when you have to do it for every meal, it
that's
fucking
tough.
Takes a toll on your body.
Why, me and Ricky might as well move. We cook never.
Oh, but
yeah,
like,
Peter never eats out.
Even if it's like one thing, or even if you have like after you have food, like go out like 3 days in a row, you're like, all right, let me.
Me
eat
and
at
Ricky
home.
Are so sick of eating out, we can't stop eating out.
One of you,
yeah. It's
honestly,
it's
when
it's
you
bad.
I know that feeling, man. It's terrible.
When you get to choose it, it's nice. But after a week of not,
dude, when a BLT
choice,
tastes better
awful.
Than going to fucking like Outback and shit, you know you ate out too much.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Like, she
made bacon today. I thought she was like a goddess. I'm like, oh, babe, you made it so good.
A little blood.
She was all excited.
She's
like, oh my God, he loves my cookie.
I barbecue tonight. Shit.
You can put bacon on anything. It's good.
No, but she doesn't make breakfast at all. She hates making breakfast.
Yeah, I hate making breakfast.
She hates pizza. She hates making breakfast. And she hates.
You hate bacon?
But she loves tacos, man.
Wait, she's going to say, I don't hate pizza. I just don't like it as much as I used to.
I don't like it all the time either. But I do hate making breakfast.
And
I'd
she doesn't like making breakfast or dust.
Don't you dare. I haven't seen
Let's just air all the grievances
I will
now.
Say this, though. I'm very proud of her. Today she's like, our place is disgusting. I need to clean it. I almost fell on the ground.
Listen, I've cleaned that place.
I have never heard her say that in my life.
At least once a week since we've moved
she
in.
Does, but I've never heard her say, this place is disgusting. I need to clean it. Never. She comes so far. Like, last week, we were both starving because I got home and there was no dinner. This week, she's like, should I just go get something before you get home so you have food when you get here? And I'm like, oh, my God, she's learning.
Well, because I
wow.
She's learning.
I don't want to feel the wrath of Peter.
There's no wrath.
Oh, my God.
I'm no bully. I just don't talk.
That's
worse.
When I get
like,
mad, I just don't talk.
Being ignored is the worst. Kind of punishment.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Would you rather me
yes.
call you a name, or would you rather me just not say anything?
I'm not sure. I might rather be called
that's,
a name.
No, that's a good.
You don't like the names I call.
No,
you.
But that's a good question.
You don't like the names I call you when I'm mad. So I don't say anything.
Got real.
Wait, are you still there?
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, what? I have a wife that doesn't like touching me when it's gross.
No.
Like
no.
This cut, it's taking her. Every bit of fucking fiber in her body. to even look at it.
It's not because I don't want to help him. I just have a hard time with it. I'm going to.
She can't.
No, it's tough. It's tough.
She's turning into a wife slowly but surely. But there's a lot of awkward, quiet nights.
Yeah.
Well.
A lot.
That's
Well, we air out Mike and Kathy's here, right?
Oh, jeez.
Oh, yeah, what happened with that? Like, last I saw, they were fighting.
We cause a fight every time they're together.
Oh, really?
Oh, we make sure.
Are they still together? What the hell's going on?
We don't know yet.
What happened that night? Because I, like, left it.
Oh, they went home. They banged.
Okay. That's good.
Well, that's the best sex. It's makeup sex.
Absolutely. Oh,
yeah. Ricky wouldn't know.
Oh, you don't fight.
No, we fight.
No, we fight.
We just don't have sex.
Oh, yeah, you just don't have sex.
Make me breakfast, bitch.
No, we fight, and I go to Rhode Island.
I feel like with you two, it's not makeup sex. It's like, oh, I just recovered from some injury or illness.
I want breakfast in bed.
For the past 8 weeks, it's like, fight Rhode Island.
Yeah.
Ah, so you run away.
We didn't fight last week.
Like a
no,
Tuesday.
We didn't fight last week.
Rhode Island keeps the relationship strong.
It does.
And Candy Crush.
She almost did really good last
Soda
week.
Soda Crush.
She almost made it through the whole week without making a comment.
I did.
No. I look back to Friday. Friday, you were like, well, you didn't call me last night.
Oh, because you said that you would call me before
I said, I'm going to lay down. I have Benadryl. I'm taking Benadryl. If I wake up, I'll remember to call you and say goodnight. You know what Benadryl does to a person?
Knocks everybody out.
Done.
No,
Benadryl
normal,
and I was in pain because this thing started to grow.
So you had that sleep of like, I just want to be done.
I just want to be done. Yeah. And I Skyped her and I talked to her before I took the Benadryl.
Does, but I didn't like dwell on it. I just
no,
I
but
said
you
one
made
thing.
You
I
know
like,
when they're mad when they make like a little comment.
Benadryl
no.
also a really good.
No, you wouldn't
name.
Know if I was
so
mad.
So you Ooh. Read into things.
Yes, he does. For
no,
you read into things. Yeah,
oh,
Peter,
yes.
you do.
Don't give yes. me a book and tell me not to read it.
Wait, there's different interpretations to
no.
every book. Yes,
you wrote the paragraph. You told me to read it. I'm reading.
Everybody
that,
interprets damn. A book differently.
When somebody at all right, so I didn't call her. So the next day shouldn't it have been not anything at all, but the next day was. You usually call me.
I didn't say you usually call me. I
you
said
me,
you
want
didn't.
Go back.
Go ahead.
Back.
That's not what I said.
Uh-oh.
Stenographer, can we get the transcript?
Where did he go?
I thought the accusation was still there.
I thought you were going to call me. I'm sorry.
Was still there.
That's what she said. I thought you were going to call me before you went to bed.
And it was my
meaning,
dad.
I'm pissed. Because
no.
he didn't call me.
No. I wasn't pissed. See, that's where you're wrong.
You're reading things into it.
And Peter, how does
yes,
that make
you
right.
He does all
Peter,
the time.
Peter, how
does
that make you feel?
How does that make you feel?
Trust me.
Other than horny, because you're rubbing your nipple right now. And
no,
it's really
I'm scratching
weird.
Myself.
Listen,
you call
rash.
Your
spreading.
Your rash.
My rash. Oh.
The rash is spreading.
My rash.
And his taint is gone.
But she's getting so far into it that she doesn't realize she says things.
No, because you
see? Always confrontational.
Yes, because I don't always mean things the way that you think I'm saying them.
Call Sprint and have them send you transcripts of
yes.
my texts, please.
Yes.
And
see how
and
you
tell me what
it.
You read. Because if I'm wrong, then I will apologize on public radio right now.
Ricky,
can
I
you do that, you. Please? Can you?
Ricky,
I don't read
so
into shit.
Bob, is that a phone? What the fuck?
Yeah, what is that,
like
Bob?
That's
the
Ricky.
Biggest fucking phone I've ever seen in my life.
It's called a tablet.
Oh, I thought it was a cell phone. I knew that. Like, oh, my
well,
God.
Well, they say
it was like
they
ones.
Say your phone should be the size of your girlfriend's box.
It's a good box, I promise you that.
It's a Magnavox.
You can see my phone's really small.
It makes me go boing, 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 boing.
She's a big ship, but she gets across the water.
Listen,
oh, no,
I'm
no,
not
no,
trying to make Ricky seem like a bad person. She's not. She just misses
she's a
me
sweetheart.
Tremendously.
She loves you.
But,
yes.
But
even my friend at work said it doesn't even know her. He's like, we were driving back from the restaurant. I better call my wife. He's like, dude, you just talked to her 5 minutes ago. I go, I know, but she gets worried. And he's like, she just misses you. I'm like, you don't even know her and you're on her side?
I do miss him, but... Sometimes he does take things the wrong way.
But everybody does.
I've seen you
but
do it, Peter.
The problem is, I'll tell you what the problem is. The problem is that it's a
fucking court stenographer.
The problem is
it's all like, no, Peter,
no.
you said it. Fucking
no. I take things the wrong way sometimes, too. The problem is that it's text, and you don't know what the person's thinking.
So if I said I'm taking Benadryl, I will call you if I am awake to call you. Should there be a comment after that at all?
Yes, I did make a comment, but I wasn't.
I'm really
far
into it, though.
But it should
but
be.
But I wasn't pissed.
But why make the comment?
Because I wanted to make the comment.
Let's hear from the bar guy.
Wanted to let you know that she missed
okay,
wow.
Hang on. Here's
hey,
my
let
thing
bar
with
guys
that.
Be bar guys.
Hang on.
So why can't.
Why is it that, like, everyone assumes that because someone's bi, they had this, like, omnipotent
you have emotion.
Fucking, like,
Yes, I know what both genitals.
You have emotions.
No, it's because you play both sides.
And I fuck up too, man. Are you kidding me?
Yeah, but why say something if you're not mad? Why not say nothing at all?
She just wanted to say something.
Nothing's a bigger interpretation.
That means
I can see both sides.
Sometimes nothing's better than something.
I can see both sides. I can see where you'd be like, why the fuck do you got? Why can't you just let it go?
Yes.
Like, because I just
I didn't call you. Here's the problem. I knew she's gonna be like that, so I hesitated to call the next day. Yeah. So on the next day, when it became 7:30, she's like, "Oh no, morning call today."
Yeah.
See, but I'm reading into it.
But
I'm reading into it.
Yeah, that was
But guess what? My answer was, I never take. But I am never late for work in my life.
I just woke up.
I woke up at 7:30. I never listen. You just heard me. I get up every day at 4:30.
Yeah.
I took a Benadryl and woke up at 7:30.
I should have put you until like.
I have never been late to work in my life, and I fucking and I live on that. And she knows that about me. She's like, no morning call. Instead of saying, "Oh my god, I didn't hear from you at 7. Are you okay?" No morning call.
But I wasn't
I'm all fucked up. No. I'm pulling crusties out of my eye at 7:30. I got to be at work at 8, and I'm going, I just woke up. Why are you yelling at me?
All right, hold on.
What is wrong with you?
Wait, crusties a new staff infection.
There are plenty of times that I have been pissed at you for things like that.
Can we go to that day and not the past?
I can honestly say that.
Can we go to that day and not the past?
No, you won't let me fucking talk.
No, because you're going to justify. You're going to justify what you did Friday by what you didn't do months ago. Let's talk about the day at hand.
I was trying to get to the day
at
hand.
Go ahead. Let's hear it.
Jesus fucking Christ.
Let's hear it.
I wasn't pissed at
him. He's not listening anyway.
No, he's not.
Yes, I am. I can hear him.
You, Peter.
Yeah, but you're not listening.
I'm listening. No, I want to hear this explanation.
Yeah, all right, 20 minutes ago.
I want to hear this explanation. Oh. Go ahead.
Ejaculation got to wait.
I wasn't pissed. That's why I made one comment, and then I dropped it. Normally, I would have kept
going
on it.
But why couldn't you say good morning? Why couldn't – I mean, I'm going to tell you this right now. I go through this with my girlfriend right now.
I'm not saying
Why not just say – good morning, how are you?
Mm-hmm. Are we arguing over semantics?
No, it's just...
Wow, it got real quick.
Yeah, somehow I'm like, I'm not going to be in the middle. So it's like divorce court. I'm like, fucking...
I understand where the two of you are coming from on that, because I do, my girlfriend and I, we do that right now, but good morning, how are you? I mean, instead of saying, oh, I didn't hear from you, I mean, just...
But the assuming part was I didn't call her.
But you can call her every morning at 7 o'clock.
So am I not human? Can I not sleep late one day?
No, see, that's...
I took Benadryl because I was in pain.
That's where I agree with
you. So you say back to her, I took Benadryl and overslept.
I did.
And I dropped it.
Right. And she dropped it.
No,
what the hell?
That's pretty good, Peter. You can't get better.
No, you kind of got off on that one. It's done.
There are I'm not.
Peter, it could have been way worse.
In her eyes, she dropped it.
No,
but okay.
I did drop it. I was in a good mood the whole day. And normally, when you're away, I'm not in a good mood.
She's from Bridgeport. She knows how to sell things. Just remember that.
Oh, okay.
Wow.
Everything I say, he wants to turn around.
No, because there shouldn't be a jealous point at all.
Exactly.
When I spend every minute of the day, unless if I'm not in Rhode Island, if I'm not in Rhode Island.
It's all about Peter.
How is it about me when I spend every minute with her, unless I'm at work or I'm here? And when I'm here, I'm not spending every minute with her still. So there shouldn't be a fucking inch of jealousy or an inch of comments. Why didn't you call me when, if I'm not with you, you know where I am. There shouldn't be any comments at all. Call me caveman.
Hey, hold on a second.
Call me caveman.
Okay.
But.
So you usually call her every morning at 7 o'clock. At 7:30, she's worried because she doesn't know what happened to you because you haven't called.
Instead of saying, are you okay?
Or
you usually call me.
See, but that's the thing. Hang on.
That's the same thing.
Wait. See that moment right there. That can be interpreted two different ways.
That's right.
That's either, hey, you usually call me, and or
is there something
you usually fucking call me in the morning?
The way it comes across.
The problem
it's like a statement. Oh, you didn't call me.
No.
Take it the wrong way. I see where it's not.
Like, hey, you usually call me in the morning.
That's the problem.
If you're used to it. And it doesn't happen. I mean, there's a lot of ways to bring it up.
But okay, so what if I was in an emergency room?
She's mad at me. What if I was in an emergency room?
Yeah, the fucking hospital would have called.
No, because no one knows you. What if I was in an emergency room? She would have been for 4 to 5 hours of, where the fuck are you? Fuck you.
No, she wouldn't have done that. She would have freaked out if you didn't respond.
I got arrested. I got arrested, yes, and for 3 hours,
yes,
she couldn't get a hold of me. She assumed I was doing something wrong.
Exactly.
Well, it was 3 o'clock in the morning.
See?
But
that's what I'm talking
wait,
about.
Wait, so you're saying getting arrested, right, you didn't do anything wrong?
Oh, no.
Hang on.
No,
like,
wait, Peter.
You
let's
skipped over you. Something there.
But you know what? Here's the thing.
She couldn't. I was 3 cells over listening to my phone ring, and I can hear it in the ring.
Because then I was
you
worried.
Motherfucker.
No.
But all
answer the fucking phone.
She has a police scanner, so she.
No.
But listen, usually, even if you're out, you usually answer my calls. So then I was worried. Then
right, but,
I was really worried because I
but,
called you numerous times and you weren't answering. I'm like, what the hell
but
happened
he did,
to him?
He did put to you that he was taking Benadryl.
Yeah, but he takes Benadryl all the time.
No, but Benadryl's not a get-out-of-jail-free card or anything.
No. But there's a way to go. I mean, everybody knows.
Dennis, when I go to Rhode Island and I have nobody in that room, I don't even need my CPAP machine. Oh,
you know what? I don't even care about that night because I didn't even
I'm
have
out.
An issue with that.
Literally,
no, I know.
You, if you were looking for me, you're like, what's wrong with Peter?
Well,
we ain't going there.
The past 8 weeks,
that's
how much
a bigger
have you
problem.
Seen me on Facebook
anywhere? What if you guys have a schedule, right? You talk when you talk and you do stuff, right? How about you just send each other, I'm safe, I can't talk now.
I do.
But he was out
but
cold,
he fell
though.
Asleep. He
yeah,
passed
he was out.
Out
cold.
Fell asleep, bro.
But so you woke up to that text.
I woke up at 7:30 to that text. You usually call me.
But then you could just respond, oh, I overslept.
I did.
And then she dropped
and
it.
And I dropped
though.
It.
No, she didn't.
Yes, I did. That
did
day
she
I
no. No. She dropped
there
it.
There are other Wait. Times. That, see, then you can throw your eyes.
Because she didn't drop
that
it.
You can't be like.
I dropped it that day.
Yeah.
She drops
like
it with
a
bitch face,
it.
Though.
No.
No, I bet
who cares what face she drops it with?
I
if she dropped, she dropped
fine.
It.
You know what? You can sound like, all right, you're the victim and I'm wrong.
No,
you're wrong.
No.
I actually agree with Pete
no.
on this one.
I'm going to tell you something. You don't ever hear us fight when it's Monday through Friday when I'm home. But the minute I leave for fucking Rhode Island and until I get back, it's a fuck you, it's a this, it's a that.
Listen,
so keep being the victim,
no,
but I'm, tell the truth while you're at it.
I'm not being the victim, and
you
I
are.
Said that there are plenty of times that
oh,
that has
I'm not,
happened.
I'd love to be a fly in the car and
I'm
fly home.
I'm admitting that there's other times that that has happened.
So admit that you're jealous. A lot.
Yes, I'm
okay,
jealous.
That's it. That's all people need to hear.
What does that have to do with anything?
Because that's all people need to hear, too.
But
all
right,
what's that got to do with
you're also, you're no, worried. No, you're worried, about. But you're more jealous, and you don't want people to think you're a fucking
okay,
a maniac.
But you do
so
the
you,
same type of things to me.
No, I do not. I never ask you where you are.
Yes.
I don't tell you not to go out with friends. I never do that. Don't even put that on.
I didn't say that.
Pete, you
want to
go out Saturday night?
I would fucking. If Ricky said I'm going out with my friends, I'm like, okay. Do you need money? That's what she don't understand. If I said that, it's okay. But it's the look, and it's the face, and it's the... Because I know what I did a year ago. And if you keep telling a dog that he's rabid, he's going to be rabid. I've been trying to tell you this 100 times. If I want to go out with my friends, you can't worry about what I'm going to do. Because I'm going to do it. Regardless, I'm going to do it more now if you tell me not to. I've been trying to tell you this since I met you.
I
yeah, but that's a teenage attitude.
You know what? No, because I'm,
yeah,
more,
it is.
I'm more afraid to ask my wife to go out with my friends, and I shouldn't be like that at 46. I should be able to say, Ricky, I'm going out with Bob for 4 hours. I'm not going to do coke. I'm just going to have a beer or two, and I'm going to come home. But it's not that, because
I
the minute
it.
I
you
leave and the minute I come home, it's a worry about
you know
me.
What? I've got to agree
it's
with
it's not
him.
Fair.
I have to agree with this.
And I'm not going to go do it, Bob, because she's forbidden
oh,
me.
Oh, Pete,
I didn't mean it that way.
Pete, hold on.
But
Pete.
The minute I'm not in her presence, she thinks I'm doing that.
Pete,
and
hold
it's
on.
Not fair to me no more, because I've been good for a year.
Hold on. I'm going to agree with you on this, and I'm going to tell you why. In my previous relationship with my ex,
hold on. When your relationship has nothing to
no,
do with
no,
theirs.
No, but I know where he's going with this because I encouraged my ex fiance, go out with your friends, have a good time. I need to go out with my friends, have a good time. No, every Saturday night had to be me
Ricky
and her.
Can't do that. She worries too much about what I'm doing
right.
when I'm not with her.
Right, and that's where everything went wrong with my.
You guys
ex-fiance.
Are an addict. You don't know the things. You don't know what I deal with.
I mean,
and it's not her fault. I'm not. I love Ricky to death. Don't get me wrong. She, as soon as I leave the house, she's a mess. And my stag, she was constantly worried.
I think one of you
because I was around. But I was around a bunch of people that were doing coke, and I did fine.
I think yeah. Ricky's part dog because as soon as you leave the house, she's like whimpering in the corner.
No, she's
no, but
she, out the window.
I know exactly where Pete's. Going
I don't blow out that.
I know exactly where Pete's going with this. Like
she can't. It's as a grown man, Bob. Would you want to be with someone that won't allow you to go out? Or wait a minute, gives you a hard time with their faces and their expressions. Yeah.
But isn't that every comedian's setup ever?
It doesn't even have to be a word said to you. It's just the way it makes you feel.
Peter, I have already decided that
I know
no way,
you did, yeah.
Right.
Okay, that I can ever live with someone again because of the fact that I just am set in my ways now. Right. I cannot give up anything of what I do.
Exactly. But I changed my ways for her, and she can't figure that out yet.
I'm trying to get better with it, and I told you
that. Trying. How long
Peter,
before
Peter,
it's been one year.
That's a long time. But
for
an addict and someone living with an addict, that's not long.
It hasn't even been a year, if you think about it.
Okay.
But it's okay for me to go out and drink.
It has been a year.
It's okay for me to go
They were
out.
Together when I first met them.
But Bob, it's okay for me to go out and drink with her by my side?
I'm talking marriage.
Shouldn't you worry then?
She can see what you're doing.
So did I marry my mother or did I marry my best friend?
You got to have trust.
Both. Hang on. What he means is it's easier to be in a situation where like you're there and you can physically see what's happening as opposed to being at home and just like,
but
okay, text
is
the best I can do.
But at the same time, you have to have trust.
And this is why.
Well, hold on. You know, you have never lived with an addict then.
Yes, I have.
Well,
yes, I have. My ex-fiance.
It's bullshit. Because I'm going to tell you something.
Bullshit. My ex-fiance is a coke addict.
And you don't trust her.
No, nobody trusts nobody.
And you never trust her.
I did.
Nobody trusts nobody when it comes to drugs. You don't trust
your kids. Exactly. That's what I'm saying. And it's going to take her a while to get comfortable with the fact.
But here's the thing. But, all right. I hear what you're saying. It's going to take a while. But you know what you keep hearing? I'm trying. 3 years later, I'm trying.
That's not three years.
But wait, you're jumping ahead.
But you know what?
A year gone by, you married me knowing what you fucking did. So guess what? Now what I'm going to do if I really want to party, because I'm a driving drug addict. You know what I'm going to do?
You're going to do it.
Ricky, I got to go to Rhode Island for a week, and I have very little access to phone, and I need $300 for my room.
And
I'm going to do all that.
Yeah.
But I'm not doing that. And I could do that easily.
Exactly.
And she's going to see right through it. She's going to see right through it because she knows that it could happen.
But that also kind of, I don't know, for me, just like you saying that would make me a little worried.
That's right.
Like, when you're like, I could do
That's
this right now.
But guess what?
No, but you know what?
You
got to trust your companion.
But guess what? Don't.
But guess what?
Yes,
can,
you do.
Wait a minute. I can go to Rhode Island.
You know what, Bob?
I can go to Rhode Island and Skype the whole week. But the ride from Rhode Island to Hartford or back to Milford, for those 2 hours, guess what I could be doing?
You could be doing it right there.
I could be partying, and she wouldn't know.
But exactly. That's the thing. No one's questioning.
Oh, yeah, hey, Peter.
I know when I get home she wouldn't know?
Know?
Of course, after I get home. But for those 2 hours, I'm in heaven.
But you got to trust your companion at the end of the line.
Think
if they break that
questioning
trust, that's it.
Your resolve or the fact
when somebody has blind faith, they get blindly slammed.
So what? So one person should live in a prison because the other one has no trust?
No, you build the trust.
Why should I build it?
Because you're the one who's the addict.
No, okay, then why marry me in the first place?
It should be built both ways.
So I love you enough to marry you, but I don't love you enough to trust you.
Exactly.
So you're going to live by my rules, and if you don't like it, I'm going to make your life miserable.
It's got to be 50-50.
And you can't go out with your friends, and you can't go do this with your friends, and you can't go do that with your friends.
That's not fair. It has to be a 50-50.
And that's how
thing.
A person relapses. But,
exactly.
And you know it. As much as you want to argue with him, because I know he's easy to argue with, but you, when you push somebody to relapse, you're going to relapse.
But it does take time. I understand what you're looking for is a definite timeline to say. Hey,
no, I don't want a timeline. I just want to be able to. I spend 99% of my time with my wife, and I love it.
Right.
You didn't hear me. I love it.
I understand.
But if there ever were to come a day when I wanted to say, I'm going out with Dennis, Bob, and Ed, and Bob. I don't want that attitude that day, but I'm going to get it.
Hey, Dennis. Dennis.
But at the
that's
same
never
time,
going to change.
It might, though. That's
it won't.
Hey, Dennis.
Well, I think you can be wrong there.
The time? Okay.
It won't because there's one person in the crowd that parties, and she knows it.
The trust is set when you say the
I
do.
If I say going to Naugatuck, that's it. I'm not trusted.
Right. The trust is
if
set
I
when you say
If I drive by Waterbury,
I
Baba, I'm not trusted. But I can live in Bridgeport for a year and was trusted. Because it's her environment. It's what she's used to.
It's got
to
be a 50-50.
You understand what it
is?
It's she's trusting me with her stuff. So put me in Bridgeport as a cokehead, you're fucking retarded.
And
I will find a place to get it.
And Bridgeport's worse than Naugatuck.
Yes, that's what I'm saying.
New Haven's worse than Naugatuck.
That's what I'm saying. You have to, just because a person's an addict, you shouldn't shun them for the rest of their life.
But that's what,
you see what I'm saying?
Yeah, that's what
because I'm going to be an addict. If you want me to be an addict, I'll be an addict.
You are an addict.
Of well, course,
you know what?
Be
it's
one.
Like an alcoholic. You're always
but
an
you've
alcoholic.
But you've never seen
but
me deny
go.
It.
Yeah.
Right.
And every day I wake up and I say, not today.
Right.
And I do that every day.
Right.
Okay. I love my wife, not today. I love my kids, not today.
Right.
I love
right.
my wife, not today. That's 365 days ago.
Yeah.
I love my wife, not today. I love my life, I love my kids, not today. Every day.
Yeah.
It's when, all right, so you get 365 days of doing well, there's no praise. It's little, very little. But the minute you go out or want to be with your friends, there's that fucking resistance. And that's what hurts the person. There's that, you used to call me, or you used to do this.
It's a tough situation.
I'm trying to explain to you how I live, Bob. Not how you know an addict. You have different addicts in your life.
Yeah, I've got
you don't know this one. You don't know that one. You don't know that one. Triggers. You want to know what a trigger is?
At the end of the day,
I can't have.
I know what a trigger is.
Okay, I can't have the sauce at the onion at the blossom. First thing she does when we go there, what do you think the first thing she does? By me telling you, is what's the first thing you think she does?
Moves the sauce.
How far?
Away from you.
Thank you.
Right.
I move it.
Is that
to
a good
me,
thing?
Because I use it.
Plus, she
it is delicious.
She says it's for her, but in her head,
I eat it.
She knows why. She knows why she can't, I can't have that.
Yeah.
But that's not why I move it off the plate. I literally put it right next to my plate so I can use it.
But I guess,
so,
Ricky, I have a question for you. If would you do the same thing with another boyfriend or your ex?
Would you not.
Text them, talk to them, too?
She would not.
Well, let her.
Can you say that again?
I said, please? Is this something that you're doing, I guess, in your relationships? Is this the only something you're doing with Peter? Or did you also, like, check in with your ex-boyfriends, stuff like that?
She couldn't stand her exes.
No, but it would depend on the person. I mean, and what kind of relationship you built with them and what kind of habits you formed.
Okay. I was just curious. I was just curious if this is just like.
All right, so would you take the sauce away if you and Dennis went for dinner?
Hang on.
No, because.
No, thank you.
Hang on.
Because I'm assuming he's going to use it also.
I can't because it's got green vegetables.
So then I would
say, Peter. No, but he beats right on that.
Why can't you leave the sauce in the middle of the table and trust me that I'm not going to
touch it? It's a great argument.
I'm not.
You don't use
it.
She's using it.
It's sauce. You got two people. I'm not worried about you using it.
Peter, you got two people at the table, right?
Mm-hmm.
One can't use the sauce. The other is using the sauce, so you bring it to you.
Yeah, I'm double dipping.
Right.
I'm doing all kinds of stuff with that sauce.
Peter, I agree with you.
Put it in a purse. We never got
to
talk.
It's a great argument.
He knows you agree. Hang on. I get what he means because my stepfather is an addict. Always will be because he's kind of a fuck-up. So I've seen what it does
Peter.
To a family. Well, no, my stepdad's a fuck up. He never got clean.
All right, anyway.
So I get where they're coming from as far as, like, I know, I don't know, but I can see how stressful it is every day having to say, not today, and fighting that battle every single day, and then just saying,
and then
you know
not
what?
Being trusted on top of it.
And then, being like, you know, this weekend, I deal with the stress all week long. I want to go out and just hang out with guys and get drunk.
But you know, there's also a way to rebuild the trust.
Hang on, there's a way. He's on my side.
I know, but I'm just saying.
He's on my side.
I don't interrupt you. Let me talk. So I get that, but I can also see from the other side where it's kind of like because she can't possibly know what's going on in your brain all the time. It'd be ridiculous if she did. So it's hard to just kind of hope. Like faith is a really hard thing to hang on to.
If I'm in your house and I'm not out there,
yeah.
Why worry?
Right.
If I'm in a place where you know where I am,
yeah.
Why worry?
But that's the thing we're talking about.
I never give you an
addict.
Okay.
No,
but I'm in front of
no
you.
Excuses. No,
it is.
Wait a minute. If I'm away from you, away from an hour, and you don't know where I am, and I haven't texted you or anything, worry. Correct.
Yeah.
But if I'm with you, if I just texted you 5 minutes ago saying I'm at Wild Wings,
yeah.
with my friends that I'm at work with. I'll text you in 20 minutes. Within 15 minutes, she's already worrying, why is he out not texting me?
Yeah.
And I wasn't a drug addict that bad to where I would leave for a week.
Yeah.
I was just doing it while she's at work and she came home and...
Yeah.
And like it wasn't said, where I was away for weeks at a time or stealing from her purse. Or there's levels of drug use.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. But I'm saying that's why I can see kind of where, like, she kind of jumped the gun with the text in the morning, but I can see where, like, oh, he usually calls me at the time of day. Let me just say, hey, like, are you all right?
That would have been a better approach to me.
I think that's what she meant. I think that's what she meant by the text. Am I wrong in saying that?
No, you're not wrong. But I can really say that other texts, I might have meant more of that.
Well, yeah.
But
well,
that
nobody's
one
perfect.
Text, I seriously, like, that wasn't even.
Ask her a question about me going out.
What do you mean?
And look at her face and don't even look at mine. Say, me and Peter going out. What do you think? Is that okay?
You look there.
Look at her face while you're saying it.
What do you? I don't understand what
you say, Ricky. I want to take Pete out for a night. What do you think?
So let's say,
look at her face while you're saying, right?
"Look at me."
This weekend, I want to take him out to Three Sheets. Me, him, and Sacco and Bob are all going to get drunk. Bob Clark's not fucking
allowed.
That
wouldn't bother me.
I ain't allowed to go out. That's right.
I can tell you, it's who he goes out with that bothers me.
Okay.
Really?
Yeah.
What if he leaves his phone at home?
I can honestly say that.
So you know what?
All right. So
can you tell Ricky you and I are going out this weekend? Because I'm going to go hang out with Bob.
So you can't do that. That's fucked up. You can't lie to her. Now you're lying to her.
You're planting the doubt in a weird way.
And you're breaking the trust that she might have built.
No, I'm saying I could do that. Yes, I'm not saying I will do that.
Yeah, but when you say that, that's got her thinking, is that what he did?
But it's a two-way street.
And Peter, too. It's a weird way.
Yes, it is.
We're not going to win, Bob. Don't.
No, Bob. No.
But no, but it's very rude. If I was like, hey, I'm not going to cheat on you while I'm gone, but
how about
I could
this?
Fuck all
I'm
these
an adult.
Women.
You're an adult. If I'm going to fuck up, then leave me. Because I'm going to fuck up regardless. I don't need you to tell me not to fuck up.
But how'd you feel
you
if
you can't
Ricky...
be my mother. You have to be my wife.
Yes.
But period.
But how would you feel if...
Like... How would I feel if she cheated on me? I'd be upset and then leave her.
Okay.
How would I feel if she had a pipe in her mouth? I'd be upset, then leave her.
But
that's
don't...
what you do.
But I feel like every
you
time
can't
you...
keep someone grounded.
I know, but every time you say that, it hurts her. Like you can just see it. Every time you're like, I could just leave right now and do whatever the fuck I want.
Okay, so I'm not justifying an addict to this addict, but when I partied, I didn't leave her. When I partied, I didn't do things. I was home.
But
I understand that, but I just think the way you say it, where you're like, okay, I'm going to go.
I'm not trusted for anything when it's not has nothing to do with her. She's putting on a different face right now, and I love her, but she can say what she wants. But if it doesn't include her.
I'm admitting to things.
Hold on.
If it doesn't include Ricky, it's a problem.
All right, hold on, Ricky. Go ahead.
Like when you just said now, if it was okay to go out, it would be fine. 2 hours later, it wouldn't be.
All right, Pete, hold on.
Because I'm not home with her.
Right.
That's the problem. If I were not with you an hour later, we would have to have met up.
All right, hold on, Pete.
I couldn't go out with you the whole night.
Right. Pete, hold on. Give Ricky a chance to respond to that.
Yeah, because
I can tell you it's who you go out with that bothers
now
me.
Now it's who I go out with.
Yeah.
All right, well, hold on.
Bob's from Naugatuck. He just included Bob.
You know what?
You're not worried?
Now, I didn't grow
you're
up.
Not worried?
Now, hold on. Because
the word Naugatuck worries you.
I didn't grow up in Naugatuck, so now remember that. There's people in Naugatuck like me who have not been there all their life. At the end of the day...
For all you know, he's a big flaming fucking cokehead.
But hold on. At the end of the day, you've got to trust each
not
other.
Not that flaming.
I was like, man, come on.
At the end of the day, you got to trust each other.
You're right.
And you know why she don't trust certain people? Because guess who was honest with her that I party with?
No, I understand.
Exactly.
But hold on.
I was honest with her.
Yes.
But hold on.
It doesn't, how do you know Dennis doesn't do coke?
It doesn't matter who you
Dennis
don't.
Has a blood clot.
So it's okay to go out with Dennis?
But
is it okay to go out with Dennis?
I used to, but I can't.
Is it okay to go out with Eddie?
Until I know otherwise.
How do you know he doesn't do coke?
I don't
So now he's my safe harbor.
At the same time, though.
How do you know Uncle Bob don't do coke?
I think there's a miscommunication here.
Well, Uncle Bob
can't
die
from
coke.
It if he did.
Yeah, he can't. You know he can't do it because he's sad.
All right, hey, we're getting to that point.
Yeah.
No, but the point is I told you who I party with. To let you know, and when was the last time I went out with any of them?
All right, on that note.
That's what I'm trying to, babe, I love you to death. You need to understand that. When I tell you, if Eddie did coke, would I tell you he did coke if I wanted him to be my friend? Because if the only time I get to go out when you're not upset is with him, don't you think? Don't you think I would keep it to myself?
It's tough.
You have a problem trusting me, still. Ricky, and that's not fair to me.
Ricky, listen,
no, she has no trust in me unless we're together.
I don't know if it's
and
about
it's not
listen,
fair to me.
I don't know if it's about trust.
It is.
No, Pete, hear me out.
It is.
Pete,
there's a lot of trust.
Hear me out. We know.
Bob don't trust his daughter every time the phone rings.
We know the people we're talking about.
Do you?
No.
Thank you.
You and I.
And when am I supposed? When? How am I supposed to get
but
that trust
at the same
back?
Time,
you
though,
will never will.
Listen.
Right. You know why? Because every time she comes up with something new.
I got you.
Listen.
Okay.
Pete,
she comes up with a new scheme. I don't.
But the thing is,
she needs to learn that and begin to develop the trust in that.
Exactly.
When does the begin start? It's been a year, so when does it begin?
But that's why she married you.
It's going now.
You've got the whole life to figure that out. That's why she married you.
I think it's called love. I think it's called hard love. I think it's called support. I know where you're going with this, Pete, because you know I've got your back in this. Some of my best friends are big-time drug addicts, and they've always have been.
Bob, stop overdrawing things.
No,
I'm saying
I'm not
when she says I'm going to learn, It's okay. So she's 2 trying. Years later, I'm still gonna hear. I'm going to
Let
learn.
It, Peter,
she's
3 trying.
Years later, I'm
Peter.
Going to learn. Peter. 4 years later, I'm going to learn. What? You don't understand, Rita. Really. She's always going
no,
to learn.
You're not trusting me that I'm
exactly.
You're worried about you're questioning me about trust.
It's both ways. It's both ways.
Peter, you're questioning me about trust.
About it,
Peter.
It's the way you guys are describing.
You're projecting. You're projecting that the situation a year from now is going to be the same as it is now.
It will be. If I'm not standing next to her, it will be.
Are you with me?
Yeah.
You're going to use that as to be a victim.
No, I'm not a fucking
victim. Guys.
Everything I say, you want to turn around.
Guys.
No, it's not turning around. So when I went out with my stag and you called me and busted my balls 5 times and said, where are
you?
That was fair to me?
As a matter of fact,
why? Because I was with Joe?
I made sure not to call you.
Okay, you know what?
Listen.
This is getting nowhere because you know what? I'm always going to be the fucking villain. God forbid I put that fucking pipe in my mouth 20 years ago. No. No, because it goes a lot fucking deeper and you know that. Okay? Because every time I go to fucking, run away like you always do. Good. I'll walk the fuck home. Go. Go.
Really?
Yeah, really. Because I don't need your bullshit lies. Your Bridgeport fucking lies.
Guys.
Fuck you.
This ain't the time to do.
Go!
This ain't the
time. Get out of my face and go! Because I'm tired of you acting like a fucking victim!
Pete, this ain't the time for it.
No, bullshit! Bullshit! Good, everybody get fucking mad at me because you don't know the fucking truth. I really don't care anymore. So sick of every week trying to defend myself.
It's tough both ways, man.
It's not! I have a fucking. I am a human, and if I want to be out, I don't need a fucking babysitter.
Bro.
Period.
Bro.
No one's seeing that point.
Pete.
You don't see what I live with.
Pete, I know you are. I come from a family of alcoholics.
You don't see what I live with, Bob. Don't
even
think about
it. Pete, I come from a family of alcoholics.
Whatever.
No,